A guy came up to me and he's like, "You can't be dancing in here like that."
He said, "Really?"
Yeah, and I was like, "Oh, I'm sorry." Like, I thought he was, I didn't know. Was there a sign? He points to the sign. No horseplay. No running.
No hip thrusting.
And then there's a video of me. Know that.
And then my girlfriend comes in like, "So, how was it?" And I was like, "Man, I'm kind of sad."
Oh, God.
She's like, "How was the psychic?" And I was like, "She said everything's not going to go all right." And then she's like, "Oh. Were you a DDR kid?"
No. Fuck you. No. Well, hold on. Let's intro the pod so we can capture all this magic. Welcome to Overshadowed, folks, the only podcast about the siblings and spouses of famous people. I'm Zach.
I'm Charles.
And last week we covered in our first two-part series, we covered James Vincenzo Capone, brother of Al Capone. So this week we're just gonna hang out, you know.
Yeah.
We've had some history-packed episodes.
We've both had a couple. Also, weeks are tough.
Weeks are hard.
Weeks are hard. Everybody's
in
got
general,
a life.
52 per year, and they're not easy.
Come on. You
a
gotta
week?
Give us a break. So
yeah.
How about you just hang out with us today?
Yeah, let's just hang out. We're back at the stand. I like coming to the stand, even though we have to set everything up, and it's difficult, and the batteries are never here. Not that they would supply us batteries, but...
It's cool to be doing
it.
It'd
be nice
like
if they threw us a battery every now and again.
It'd be nice if they gave us
throw
a battery.
Throw me a battery.
Come on, like a little punch card.
Yeah.
Here's a battery.
Yeah. Wouldn't we be punching in our time for the punch card? Oh,
yeah,
I see.
Yeah.
We come 11 times, they give us one double A battery.
One double A.
Yeah, that would be worth it.
That would be super worth it.
That would make it all worth it.
Yeah. I mean, it still is worth it, guys. We're here post 10-year anniversary at the stand.
Oh, yeah, there's
the
balloons
congratulations
everywhere.
Congratulations, balloons are up. There's a one from the 10 up in the sky.
They're separate, though. So it says con, and then I think congratulations.
Yeah, it's over there in the corner.
Stuff behind this little barrel.
It looks like it's the balloons are... crammed under like a tall bar cart.
Yeah.
So it looks like they're just blacked out. It looks like these balloons, because everybody was smoking in here too. It looks like these balloons got high for the first time.
Yeah, there was just weed on the table. Every time we come in here, it's like the aftermath of Katrina, and we're FEMA six months later, being like, "Geez, no one's cleaned this up yet?
What's going on?
This should be cleaned up.
This is America?"
I thought you guys were going to do it. So we're back at the stand. I like coming to the stand because it feels like we're going to work, you know?
It feels like we're doing something, yes.
Yeah.
And it makes the clips look way better. As far as like...
Yeah, you're right.
If you're a first-time watcher, it's
FTW.
Not like...
FTW?
You're an FTW, you don't have that thought of like, there's some fucking white guys on their couch.
Mm-hmm.
When I do see a podcast come up and it's like the background's like just, I'm like, what are these fuck boys? And then I give a time limit and then until they talk about something that I thought they were going to talk about.
Come.
Like, let me give or like Bitcoin for real.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I'm like, knew it. Boo.
Bitcoin for real? You're like getting those clips? I'll That's more of a reflection of you.
No,
you're
no,
seeing
no, no,
that
no, no.
shit.
People boost their clips. If somebody's paid
boosted.
$50 to fucking everybody in Queens gets it, people pay a lot of money. I love sending those people away. Boo. It's the closest you get to the Caesar.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Seinfeld even had that bit.
He did?
Like, when he did his first late night after a while, after like years of not being really on the scene, he was like, I feel like a gay French prince.
Oh, what was he talking about?
He was talking about just like scrolling.
Ah, that's funny.
No, not today. Not for me.
Yeah, that's good.
Man, we're like, gay's bad.
Yeah.
French is bad. Gay is bad. You go, Jerry.
Yeah, those are the words.
Dude, so I've been, this happens sometimes. I've been biking a little more.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the weather's pretty nice. It's pretty cool out, pretty crisp. And I got this lump down there. I got a lump going.
Where?
Down in the, I don't want to be so graphic out of the
gate.
Well,
you gotta tell
me.
I don't know where we're thinking here.
I got a...
On the dong?
Not on the dong.
A dong bump?
Nope. Not a ball, a taint bump.
Probably a muscle.
It's to keep all the traffic from the balls to my asshole at a reasonable speed.
Yeah.
It's a little tape.
Is it a callus? Like when you do a lot of pull-ups?
It's not a callus. It's not a callus. But I get worried because I've had it there before and it comes and it goes. You know, it knows no master. It's just hanging out. But it's gotten to the point where it's like, I think it's like the biggest it's been. So I'm like worried because also my friend recently, this is kind of sad, but recently told me that she has cancer. And I'm like, oh, my God, you're like 25, 24.
Ah.
So it's like brutal. So now I'm all worried. And I also don't have health insurance. You know, so I'm squeezing this thing, hoping it's a pimple. It's not popping. I'm like,
it's only getting bigger.
Right.
Squeezing it's the thing that
but
makes
I'm
it worse.
But I'm hoping that, like, you know, just continuing to shower and, like, it'll just subside.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because my health insurance doesn't kick in until November.
Well, you could just go to urgent care and show them your gooch. It'd be hilarious. But
health insurance, Charles. Those visits cost money.
Yeah, you have to pay the money.
I will not. I will die until Fidelis Care can chip in. All right? I'm not. I need
when
to go Dutch
kick in?
On my health care. November.
Oh, okay.
I got a month with the lump. I got to do a month with my lump.
You're choosing that choice.
40 days.
Or $120 in Clarity. But you don't want to pay the price
They're
of
Clarity. They're not going to biopsy. No, urgent care is just going to tell me to go to the hospital and
get
a biopsy.
No, but that's what I think is it's something that's so simple that somebody from the medical field would be like, no.
Well, here's what it is, because I've heard this before. You go in and they go, well, let's monitor it. And I go, okay, I didn't need to come. They're like, if it gets bigger or if it starts hurting, that's what they always say. If it starts hurting or it gets bigger, come in and we'll take a look and we'll track the growth.
I'm imagining it's just something that comes with riding a bike. So that's why if it happens when you're riding a bike,
I'll show you later.
I got to see it. And
have you ever done that for? Did you ever had to like show your privates to your parents?
No, thank God.
For any kind of disaster? Girls do that a lot.
Yeah, well, they have
they
to.
Got a lot
that,
going
that's
on.
A lot yeah. going on. A lot of stuff's happening.
A lot
of
like
blowouts.
That's like a boat
there.
Versus a bike.
Yeah.
That's how much maintenance
yeah.
they need.
Vaginas are like boats.
Yeah, they are.
Something I've always said.
I don't know. A bike does need maintenance, actually. Rollerblades. A dick's like rollerblades. You never got to do nothing to rollerblades.
Yeah, that's true. What is something else a dick is like? Look into our new segment. Dicks are like cats.
Surfboard. Sometimes you wax it, you rub it down,
there we go.
But for the most part,
every morning,
you leave it alone.
Yeah, and then when you hit the water, you have fun.
Yeah.
You see how long you can stand.
Yeah, see how long you
Surfing's
can ride.
Surfing's hard sometimes.
Surfing's hard. Sometimes you don't catch a wave.
Yes. You get close, but you can't get up. There we go.
You can't get up. The pot has begun. Yeah, so I'm worried about the bump, but you ever had a bump like that?
Yeah, when I was in Thailand, I thought I had herpes, and I went to the hospital and spent like $500, and then they were like, that's an ingrown hair, and I was like, thank you so much. Here's $500 American.
Yeah.
Which I think they went out and bought a house with, and $1 there was 33.
Jesus Christ, 33 Thai dollars?
Yeah, so three was 100.
Thai dollar signs?
Yeah. A lot of those out there.
He was the guy with the Ferraris, like, who had a weird voice, and he was short.
I think so.
Thai
dollar sign.
He was like the first YouTube rich guy.
Was he?
Yeah, so here I am, guys, in my house. You know.
Oh, that's Thai Lopez. That guy sucks.
He sucks. Who's Thai Dolla Signs?
Thai Dolla Sign is a rapper, I think, under the Young Money label.
Wow.
Yes, 100% different.
I believe he's known for, you list his
back
whole
that
discography.
Ass up, bring it back here again. Sling it to the side. A lot of dude, you just dropped the nuts. No wonder they're all over your bag.
Don't cry over spilled
nuts. It's a consequence
nuts.
Of your negligence.
Did you? No. The wire was wrapped around the nuts.
Yeah.
They're gonna get.
Just say you're negligent.
They're gonna go
man.
Blue.
These nuts suck.
Can we get into the stories?
Yeah.
We got some stories to talk about here. I went to a comic's birthday. I don't think you ended up going to. It's Solas. So I walk into Solas and there's like. It's booming. There's a lot going on. There's some good eggs, Allie O'Neill, Brittany Cardwell. So I'm talking to them. It's fun. It's nice. But it's so loud.
Mm-hmm.
It's booming music and it's super crowded. So we're like at the very front because people are dancing in the back. And like, I'm like, what are we going to do? What's the next move? Because I don't want to be yelling at you anymore. That's too much. So I'm like, does anyone want to dance? Nobody wants to dance. I'm like, how about what? You know, I'm trying to. It's so embarrassing trying to get people to dance. Like, so you guys want to, what do we think about dancing? And they're like,
yeah. Yeah, people that don't want to dance. Well, that's like the
they
last
They kind of
thing.
Act like you're a homeless guy asking for money. They like don't even acknowledge that you said that.
What did you say?
Yeah.
I have to poop, so.
That's how you avoid homeless people.
I wouldn't dance.
Do you have a dollar? I have to poop.
I have to shit, sir. I'm sorry. I have bigger things going on right now.
So I want to dance. Nobody else wants to dance. Story of my fucking life.
Yeah, you are a dancer.
Story of my life.
Yeah, you're a tiny dancer right now.
I'm a medium dancer. Thank you very much. Look at the back of my shirt. It does not say T. It says M. And
MD, medium dancer?
Yeah, medium dancer. Hold me close. No MD. Maryland. Ah. I'm the medium dancer from Maryland.
Wow.
The Maryland medium dancer.
Keep that title.
Yeah. That doesn't really have a ring to it.
Yeah, it's something with an M. If only dancing was Manson, then it'd be good.
Yeah.
You
well, it is
Mance?
When I do it. Yeah, I put the Manson romance.
Toxic Mance-ulinity.
But, like, it's comics. Comics don't want to dance. So it's tough. And like,
I'm sure just looking to gain social, you know.
They're looking to hang with a friend that they that they know, or like network.
Yes.
I'm trying to dance. I'm trying to get the week out.
Uh-huh.
I've had a week. It's Friday.
Yeah. Were you a DDR kid?
No. Fuck you. No. I wasn't. I was a Guitar Hero kid.
Okay.
I got a rhythm inside me that's got a, you know, I feel the rhythm, I feel the ride. Get on the dance floor. Yeah. It's Zachy R time.
It is our time. I'll tell you that.
I tell you, I'm dancing like an R out
you
there.
You got dance strength.
Yeah, I do have dance strength. Dance retardation. I think retardation is okay to say.
Yeah, of course.
You know, it's the long version.
It's not you that I like, it's your retardation. It's separate than, I like the person you are.
What was that first part? It's not you I like, it's your retardation. What was that?
It's not, separating it.
Oh.
The artist, the art from the artist.
Okay, I see. The beauty from what's inside.
The tart from the...
The tart from the artist. That would be the name of my first album.
That'd be great.
The tart from
the artist. The tart from the artist. What's the tard?
Is he the artist or is he the tard?
The tard is a classic tale that takes you back in time.
Sit down and listen to the tard's tale. He goes from town to town with his mandolin singing his tard tales. Give him some money if you wish. He'll sing about your heraldry and knighthood.
A tard I be, but so are you. If you look it within me, you'll see the truth. A tard within we, it's all of you.
Okay, pretty good. You got the melody right.
Yeah.
You got the vibe.
Yeah.
Dun, da, 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 dun, da.
Okay, so you're looking to dance.
So I'm trying to dance. I'm trying to.
So how are you trying to dance? Are you like in the group with people kind of like?
Yes.
You ever do that? Ah.
I'm in a circle of people.
Boo.
No, boo you.
Boo you.
Boo people you're like
you.
You're
trying to foreplay the.
I'm trying to see.
Are you talking to people? And
anybody wet? Anybody feeling this beat?
Like if I'm like, what's up, dude? You're going. You're just like, yeah, nothing, man. Like you're also enjoying.
That's okay to do. It's okay to stand in a circle talking and dancing because then, what if the person across from you catches the vibe? You know, you throw your shoulder in, they throw their shoulder back, suddenly you're mambo number fiving.
This is a fantasy that I hope comes true for
and
you.
And then I wake up.
Yeah.
It's never happened like
that's
that.
That's never happened,
that's
and we all know
that's
it.
My dream.
What if?
That's my American dream.
I need
dream.
To worry about what if, dude.
What if? What if they catch a vibe? And there's some comics who are dancing, but it's kind of like the dancing... Honestly, that I do, which is kind of manic and uninviting. There's a few comics who are like, there's a few like isolated incidents of dancing, but you can tell they're kind of just doing what I'm doing, which is just like, duh, I just got to get it out. Got to get it out of me. Are you a dancer?
No. I wish I was a dancer.
I do too.
I envy the skill of dancing.
I think our friendship would be a lot deeper.
I mean, it's way more fun laughing at it. It deepens it for me.
All right.
No, I respect it. And I'm glad that you were. No, it's just fun to think about. Because it's so different than who I am.
You never grew up dancing.
I never grew up gay.
Boom! Fatality.
No, it just...
Gay-tality. Finish him.
You grab his skull. Dick goes through the back of
you
his forehead.
You see the x-ray? You see the x-ray of the dick penetrating the back of the skull. Sub-zero. Defeated. Is it defeated? No, it says wins.
Wins.
It's
Get over here. Oh, I looked up the guy. I looked up the long guy last night for a punchline. Dalism or something like that.
What? That's a religion.
The name confused me. But you know the guy in Street Fighter that like extends? He's like a Hindu guy.
Oh, Street Fighter, no.
Oh.
I'm talking Mortal Kombat.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Anyway, okay, so get me to the dancing.
Oh, so I learned how to dance. I want to tell you a little bit about my dancing.
Wow.
If I can.
I thought this was supposed to be just a hang. Now I got to learn. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, you got to learn. Yeah, I actually prepared research. I looked at old videos of me. I looked at other styles of dancing, Eastern, Western, Northern, Southern.
All the styles. What dance did you study?
Southeast.
A lot of Southeast. Did a little bit of North when I was in college.
Yeah.
Went West for a bit before I got freaked out. We all know it's down there.
Yeah.
Don't go west.
That's a dark hole.
You end up west, you're going to, you know, eventually come east.
Yeah.
That's what they all do.
So this is how I dance. Let me tell you how I dance. I learned how to dance from my bi roommate in college. So It used to be.
How did that start?
Well, he did swing dancing.
Okay.
So I would go to, they had like parties.
Okay.
And of course, swing dancing is going to break out at the swing dancing party.
That's good. Yeah, you need to be going to dance parties.
I don't want to battle. Okay. Are you suggesting I battle? No. I know that's what you're saying.
You just immediately assumed.
You said dance parties. You know what happens at dance parties where everyone's a dancer? Two lines form, and the strongest of each gender face off.
One from the east and one from the west.
One from the east, one from the west.
What style?
Girl, I need you to run it. Run it. Chris Brown. You think this is funny? I've been, you know, because the air's getting a little crisp. Chris Brown. It's getting a little Chris Brown out there.
Let me raise you just a...
Raise me a rapper?
Just a cheesy one. Cheesy one.
Okay.
I've been watching this new porn category, ASSMR. It's just women farting. Softly at night.
Oh, I thought it was someone like pounding a lady, but like softly, and the mic's real close.
I was thinking that'd be funnier as a woman farting.
I think it's gross.
Okay.
So I learned how to dance from my bi roommate who was very hips forward in his dancing. So foundationally, I've a feminine dancing style.
Okay.
Which I've been trying to break away from because I've noticed that nobody really. My friends think, you know, dancing with me is fun. Female friends. I think it's because I'm so non-threatening and clearly gay.
You're so big hip. You're on
I'm
the dance floor.
I'm big hip. I'm fucking hitting
you
them.
You guys want to dance?
Yeah, kind of. That's a fun guy.
Yeah.
He's not going to fuck you at all.
You're right.
He can't.
You can trust him.
Yeah.
He can't fuck you.
You pull down his pants, it's Ken. It's smooth down
there.
Yeah, dude. It's just a plastic
dome. He's all hips.
Dome.
That's all he's offering.
He's all hips, no dick.
You know, it's different when you're... There's a difference between all hips and all thrusts. One of them's safer.
Yes,
there's no thrust in you, kid.
I've tried to adapt the dancing to make it a little more masculine, a little more palatable, more inviting. So there's a period where I was overcorrecting, and instead of hip swinging, I was hip thrusting, and that's a different kind of bad.
That's
kind of creepy.
That's a predatory bad.
I think it's here's what it is. My energy dancing, it's very bottom bottom energy. A guy came up to me and he's like, "You can't be dancing in here like that."
Really?
Yeah. And I was like, "Oh, I'm sorry." Like, I thought he was, I thought he was serious. I'm like, "Oh shit, man! I didn't know." Was there a sign? He points to the sign. No horseplay. No running.
No hip thrusting.
And then there's a video of me. No that. No doing that.
But he was coming up to you like a little, like a movie. He was picking you up.
You can't be dancing in here like that.
Gonna get my dick all hard, baby.
Yeah. And I'm like, "Oh, I'm sorry." And he's like,
"Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'll be in the bathroom if you want to fuck." That's what he said.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's what he said. And I was like, "Oh, thank you."
I wonder how.
Yeah, and you as well. And to you and yours, may the spirit be with you. Yeah, I didn't know how to play that off. But here's the thing. I also I sweat a lot. This goes back to this. So I'm sweating
because you're too sweaty.
Well, it looks like when I'm dancing and when I'm really getting after it, you know, I'm really high and I'm feeling it. It's like I am exercising.
Uh-huh.
Zumba is a class for a reason. You know, you sweat, you're burning calories.
Uh-huh.
So
you should take Zumba.
I should teach Zumba. Is what you meant to say.
Sounds like your style so far is that of a Zumba instructor.
By the end of each class, three middle-aged women would be hauled out in an ambulance. That's how intense my Zumba class would be. I would teach an expert-level Zumba class. But yeah, it's a lot of, you know, I'm slithering around. I'm wavy. I'm wet.
Yeah, kind of like an eel in the air.
I'm an eel.
I'm like
an air eel. Yeah, that's kind of, I would describe it as maybe a land-based eel is how I dance. like a squid who's exploring sexuality. Yeah, he's bodily and gender fluid. He's fluid.
Yeah,
in every
the
way.
Squid's the most fluid thing on earth.
Yeah, I'm a jellyfish out there. I'm wiggling around.
Yeah.
And I'm
oh,
so,
your legs.
I'm so like literally sweaty and wet. It looks like I'm way more fucked up than I am.
Ah, like you're on Molly.
It
a
looks like
bit.
I'm fucked up. I'll look in the bathroom mirror. I'm like, this guy. No one would approach this guy.
Your eyes are red. Yeah.
I smell like weed often because I've like just gone out to smoke, and that helps me lock in. Lock into the groove.
Oh, yeah.
You've turned off your targeting computers. Is something wrong? Nothing's ever been more right. I'm on the dance floor. Mm-hmm. This is where I belong. Mm-hmm. Was I a DDR kid? Fuck you. Fuck you, dude.
Sounds, to be honest, the whole time, you've been sounding more and more like one.
Yeah, you're
right.
You're
a closeted DDR kid, I'll tell you that.
No, I was never good at it. I never liked it because it's not real dancing. And that's my biggest problem with it.
Yeah, yours sounds way more authentic.
It is more authentic. It's more desperate. It's more raw.
My sister had DDR. That's how I knew about it.
I'm sorry to hear
that. But I never even... Check how not DDR I am. It was in the house. Didn't even try it.
So my ex of 4 years... Sorry, dude. Let's bask in that accomplishment for
a second. I wasn't tempted by the R.
I've been tempted by the R. Yeah. After she got on the cover of Sports Illustrated or Victoria's Secret, I think a lot of people were tempted by the R. She's not that bad.
No.
No, I hate DDR. I like Guitar Hero and stuff, but I was bad at DDR because I never grew up playing it. I would play it with my my grand ex, like, because she had it at her house, and she grew up playing it. But I sucked at
it. It's a hilarious thing to watch somebody do.
Yeah, it's so fun when they're at, you see the videos of those losers. If you do it, you're cool, and you listen to the podcast. It's only if you also listen to the podcast.
If those two things happen, you're
cool. We're
actually
going to release a Overshadowed DDR track, so you can dance along to the pod.
It's called Manstorm.
Manstorm. Oh, that's good stuff. Oh, but I love the people in public in the arcade where they're grabbing the pole.
You know, like they're giving birth.
And their legs are just skittering around.
There's Irish river dancing under
there.
Yeah. You know, the Irish people had to, like...
Their shoes are off.
You know, like, they're... Yeah. They put on a headband.
You're doing deadlifts?
Somebody's filming them.
Yeah. So here's the actual thing that happens when I'm dancing and I'm trying to find, like, someone to dance with. I'm dancing around. And there are these two girls. They're, like, 5'0", like, Latina women. They're, like, younger. They're still in scrubs. They're like, just came from work. You know, they have like Ebola on their sleeves and stuff. But they're trying to cut loose. So I'm dancing with them, you know.
How'd you go up to them?
Yeah. Estamos bailando.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And no, I'm just like around them, you know. And so we kind of, I think, like, someone comments, like one of them was like, I like your moves. I'm not kidding. I know you think I'm lying, but I'm not. I like your
moves. I'll be in the bathroom if you want to fuck, Zach. It sounds like you want all these things to happen, and you're speaking it into existence.
Yeah, they like my moves.
Oh, okay, so somebody says something.
They gusted my moves. And so we're dancing, and then they go, the other one goes, you know, you can buy us a drink if you want.
Oh, gee, I'd really love to buy two women drinks.
And I go, oh, no, thank you.
That's awesome.
And then I just keep dancing.
That's awesome.
I'm just here to dance. And then I keep, and I have a, you know, a girl. I fuck people. I don't need to fuck you. I'm here to dance. Like, this is not
probably
why I'm
felt
here.
Pretty good.
I felt like a girl. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm not here to fuck.
Yeah.
I'm here to dance.
Don't look at me for this.
I'm not trying to invest money in you so that I may fuck you.
Yeah, that's what it is.
And it's like, I'm not, I don't want to buy you. I don't want to do.
Also, I don't want
to. Have you ever been implored to, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, go ahead. I was just going to say, I don't want to. When it's two women now, what, your odds are 50-50 and you're losing double
or
the money?
Or 200.
Probably
50-50. Probably
50.
You're sweating like me?
Yeah. Smelling like weed, swinging your hips. Sounds like those girls may just be thirsty and not for dick.
Yeah, they were like, this desert of a man walked over to us.
Yeah, the original meaning of thirsty.
They're taking it back.
Yeah.
No, we meant that.
Which way do you mean thirst?
I've never been implored to hit on someone by that person. You know, it was like they were boosting themselves. You know, they were like paying to put out an ad for
them. I kind of think
that's
hot.
It wasn't. I mean, if they were hotter, it would have been.
Oh, hot. Oh yeah. 2 5'0" Latinas. Say less.
No. Dice menos. No, it was like they were like attractive. That just wasn't what I was there for. And I was like kind of taken aback. I was like, no, I just want to dance. And then it was I couldn't dance with them anymore. Like, I just disguised. This is the good thing about dancing. You can disguise your exit as dancing.
Yeah.
So I danced.
Take it back now, y'all.
Don't come back now.
You just keep walking back.
Yeah. Take it back. They're like, that song's not even on.
Two hops. You're just saying it.
Goodbye. Two hops. I'm willing it into existence.
A totally different song is playing. You're like,
Charlie Brown.
You're just going out the door.
Running down the sidewalk. Yeah. Run away. Yeah, Nick and Samantha were there too. And Samantha was fucked up on an edible.
Sick.
She's like, I took an edible. I can't even be here. I don't know where I am. I don't know what to do.
Was Nick just laughing?
Yeah, Nick was being Nick.
Nick
you
is
know?
Funny, yeah.
He's so funny. But I told him this. He wears a shell of a boring man.
Yes.
He wears the skin suit of a boring guy
at
the office.
Yeah, just a guy who's like, hello.
But he's very funny and
so
very goofy.
Funny.
But it is funny that's his, like, it's a good juxtaposition for comedy.
Yeah, I agree.
Because he's so goofy, but he seems so normal and
mm-hmm.
boring.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how he thinks of himself, too.
Yeah, like, I know. He's like, am I boring?
I'm like, no.
Am I bad? What do you mean? Like, as a guy, am I bad?
As a guy. Do I bore you?
Do I suck? That's a good how Nick suck. I don't know if I suck. Because your first thing, you go, what do you mean? He goes, like, do I just suck?
Like being a guy.
A guy, am I bad? I feel like I'm bad.
Go listen to Hypothetically. We were just on the most recent episode of Hypothetically. I think it'll be fun. But yeah, Nick Hopping, very funny comic. He has several specials on YouTube that you should check out. Did anything else happen with the dancing? Hold on. I feel like I had a little bit more with the ladies. I want to talk a little bit more about the ladies asking me to buy, like requesting to be hit on.
Oh, I can. So I've had, well, maybe in the meantime, I've had a girl like come up to me at the bar. Man, one time I had a girl, I was talking to her friend at like a bar when I was like, I remember so long ago. But I remember talking to the friend. I've been in relationships so long that, and that's not so long, but when I have to think back, I'm like, man, that feels like.
You haven't been single in a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I hadn't either, though, really. Like, yeah. I've been, I'm a, like, I posted a 6-month thing with the lady on Instagram, and someone DM'd me. They're like, you love a girlfriend, which is kind of true.
Yeah, I mean, they are good.
They're good. We should talk about me telling my mom about it, because
yeah,
I think
that
there's
was
some
funny.
Funny stuff there, but keep going with.
This won't be funny. It just I remember the one time I
guarantee it. This will suck.
You're gonna hate the way I look.
All right, Nick.
I just remember one time I was talking to a girl, and it was two girls. I was talking to one of them, and then
how many cups?
Zero cups.
Whoa!
I brought one, but they didn't want to use it.
Ew.
They're like, "I'm gonna go to the bathroom," and I was like,
"If you don't use the cup, it's not the video.
Mm-mm.
It's a different video."
I don't know if I ever saw the full video.
Hmm.
That was also before you questioned if things were fake.
Yeah,
like, it was automatically
so
like,
true.
Oh my God.
Instead of, yeah, being like, it's ice cream.
Now,
it's chocolate ice cream.
It's chocolate ice cream. Now, every UFO video, I'm like, it's the government, like, immediately. I'm already done with UFOs.
Yeah.
There's nothing I believe. No, nothing anybody really believes.
I'm like,
in.
Oh, this is a guy who used to work for Pixar. Like, he did this.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And every UFO just goes, boof, when it goes.
There's so many videos with such high production quality that are made by random people.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and
yeah, that's
like,
so true.
UFO spotting in Utah yesterday.
Now, two girls, one cup was the last unquestionable truth.
I think it did turn out to be fake.
I think it did turn out to be ice cream.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're... Oh, but then they put it up a girl's butt.
Yeah, it's still poop adjacent.
Yeah.
It's still around the poop.
Yeah.
I'm
like,
giving
it's like bacon-wrapped steak.
Full credit. I give them full credit.
Yeah.
It was poop to me, guys.
It was ice cream
poop. I consider it
poop. If I ate ice cream and pooped, it would be the same thing.
There's like a deflate gate for two girls, one cup. It was ice cream. It was poop. And you know it.
That's the same thing with girls
squirting. I've studied
the
texture.
Yeah.
I've looked at other videos of confirmed poop. And I'll tell you what, that's poop.
That's poop. If you studied poop like I did, you'd know. It's the first thing you know about the videos. It's real poop.
I've looked over the footage countless hours. This is the worst fucking bar ever.
I know, it's the worst thing in the world.
Well, good thing I stole
it. I thought that when you showed it to me, but I didn't want to offend you. They're the worst ones.
I stole it.
Good. From where?
From like a bodega.
Damn!
I know. I only stole it on record because of the outrageous bar prices in New York. Bars are so expensive. I went to get a gallon of milk on my way back from karaoke at 3 a.m. before I drove drunk home. I went to get a...
You're like, milk will sober me up.
Milk will solve it. Have you been drinking? I rolled down my window. I have a milk mustache. You could say so. You could say that.
You could say I got a lot of calcium in me right now, Doc. Huh?
Maybe if I did crash, I'd be fine because my bones are so dense.
Yeah.
And I bought not even a gallon, a half gallon of milk and a one bar, and it came out to $8 total. The one bar was as much as the milk.
I knew you were mad because you texted me that. Just paid $3.49 for a one bar.
$3.75.
Wow, I did a...
That's a lot for one
bar.
Yeah,
you should not have bought that. You didn't realize that. You shouldn't have got that. Don't try to make fun of me for your mistakes, dude. Don't try to put it on me.
Look, dude, I'm not the one who
would have bought something
who misconjugated bought and forgot to delete storage off his phone, so we lost some good video.
Okay, well, you had another thing fail, so I don't know what happened on
well,
your
look,
end.
Man, look, yours is the more reliable. The camera's always failed, okay? The phones never fail.
The phones always fail.
Let me check my phone to see if it's recording.
Yeah, I'm afraid now.
I'm afraid. You know, we always have some fun riffs, and then we lose them. We lose them to the iRobots that are trying to take us down.
Trying to make sure we don't get famous yet.
Yeah, not yet. They're not ready.
Those are the famous riffs.
Those are the famous riffs.
All the viral riffs are only audio only.
Yeah, that's true. We're going to have to animate them. So I think I was like this, and Charles was like this.
Ah, that sucks. We had some good riffs.
It's fine.
I mean, nothing's ever going to be better than that.
So I'm at Solas. Let's just do it again. I'm at Solas. I'm kidding. You were about to tell me a story About two girls, no cups.
Oh, I just remember one time I was talking to a girl at a bar. It was a bar at an open mic near the college campus, and I was just there for the open mic. But then, you know, you're getting some ASU kids watching, or just people that live in the area. Mm-hmm. And then I did a set, did well, and then, like, a girl's talking to me at a table. I'm like, yeah, blah, blah, blah. She's there with her friend. And then when the girl goes to the bathroom, her friend slides me her phone, and it's, like, number and Snapchat. And I was
ooh, Snapchat.
Ooh, that gassed me up. I was
yeah,
like,
that's a
wow.
one-way ticket to Nude Town.
Yeah, and then I started going on dates with the friend.
Whoa.
Yeah, I never talked to the other one again. She was just a conduit. And then,
yeah, jeez. I bet she wouldn't even have made you wear one. sending you Snap and phone privilege?
No, not the friend is what I'm talking. Yeah, I know.
The friend slid you her contact info. And then I started going on dates with her entire resume, and you yeah. started going on dates with a lady who was shitting the whole time.
No. I went on dates with a friend.
Who slid you the phone?
Yes.
Okay.
This was one of those.
Much funnier story if you went on the dates with the lady who was in the bathroom the whole time.
And like she slides me the phone, and I'm like, no.
You're
no.
like, can I get to her through you? I thought that's what you meant. I thought you went with like the one that wasn't even present. You started hooking up with her.
Oh, the one that I was
like,
talking
that's hot.
To
I don't know anything about her.
Originally?
Do you know what I'm saying?
No.
I thought two girls came up to you mm-hmm. after a set. One girl slid you her phone, said Snapchat, whatever. The other girl was in the bathroom, and then you started going out with the girl in the bathroom.
No, two girls came up to me. One
you
of them
burned
was,
her no. and started going out with the bathroom chick.
I'm saying that a friend swooped, and it was so hot. Made me feel so hot. Oh. I started going out with her.
Wow.
And I was like, it felt like I was swooped up by I was like 24. She's probably 28. So it was like, you know, 4 years older at
yeah,
that time,
yeah,
you're
yeah.
like, whoa. It's like yeah. a senior and a freshman moment. But the Ooh. Senior's like, I would fuck you.
Right.
And you're like, but then we just got drunk all the time. You ever do that? You date somebody that gets hammered?
Yeah. And you're like, they're so fun.
They're so fun. We get wasted
in
and drive.
Words, I like
love
being
it.
Drunk.
I like being drunk
I'd
and driving
love
her. With
I
her.
Love, yeah. I love being drunk. That's what yeah. her name is, really.
Yeah, really. You know when you see them, like you always meet them at a bar, and you're like, hey.
Right, and then yeah. You go over, and they pop open the wine mm-hmm. immediately. That's like the activity. It's like you drink and whatever else.
And then at one point, you kiss publicly at a bar.
Of
that's
course.
Fun. A makeout
yeah.
at a bar.
A tipsy bar makeout?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Because you're being a little more aggressive than you would be if you had no alcohol in you.
Yeah, you don't care.
You don't care.
You're releasing your inhibitions.
Yeah. I see. It is fun because you see people do everything in New York, including like passionately kissing one
yeah.
another before they like leave.
Yeah.
Oh, like I walk you to the train, and then you walk into the train, and then you got to give them a passionate little smooch right
yeah,
in front of the
end. Passionate one. It's disgusting.
Yeah, holding
sometimes
your face.
You see that,
I hold face
like,
on the sidewalk.
You do?
I hold face.
You hold face?
I hold face. I got one on the cheek, one on the face, and...
Oh, wow. You're really setting
oh, yeah,
in,
man.
Dude.
Yeah.
You're getting it's like a roller coaster setting for you. Here comes Luke.
Yeah, and then I buckle myself into her backpack, and then I just ride
jump
her,
off a bridge.
Ride her to work.
Oh, she just flips down and you're on her back?
Yeah. It feels like I'm flying. Yeah, but my head's hitting the sidewalk.
I'm too tall.
I'm like no. a I'm like a dog's balls. They're just like jangling yeah. all like haphazardly.
Yeah, dog's balls
dog's
dangle.
Balls are just do they hurt? They're jumping around so much.
I know they definitely.
I want to give them a little loincloth to keep the package all
yeah.
secure.
I like to give them a safety staple or something. Pin them up to their stomach.
Yeah, that's very kind of you.
Yeah, it wouldn't hurt. Just a little. Like a clip-on bow tie.
Yeah.
Just kind of put it into sport mode.
Okay, so you had the two girls. I see. Okay.
Yeah, it was just trying to be like, I felt hot.
Yeah.
You felt like you were being, I just wanted to share a quick.
Well, I have another thing. I have the big beach. I have a big story about the beach.
Okay.
It's a big story. Do you want to go?
No, you can go.
Do you have anything?
I have little things. I work from home. I have like dumb things that I pried from last week. If you have stories, they'll be better.
Okay, my cool. So if you're worried we missed the clip, don't worry, dude. We didn't miss nothing because
okay.
I haven't even told the beach story.
Okay, hit me.
God, we're so nervous the cameras are going to stop. I hate it. Sorry.
Dude, you lose everything. Where is it?
Charles really knows how to get my goat sometimes. God, you're just getting my goat all the time. Like, I don't lose everything. That was my immediate emotional
I know,
response.
I
what?
You look and catch it. This guy's really getting my goat.
Getting my goat.
Yeah, was that a guy who liked to fuck his goat and somebody else
no,
got him?
No, you go straight to fucking the goat.
What else are you going to do with it if you're getting it? You think somebody stole goats?
Your goat. No, it's like someone who's
rules
like,
rules,
oh,
man.
I really...
Your goat is mine.
Your goat is mine.
But where did it originate?
Your goat is mine. And that's a fact. I got your goat, your goat. I'ma fuck your goat.
That would work.
I got your goat, your goat. Little bit of that goat. Wrap it all in gold.
Whatever, Bruno.
Oh, there's a one up there.
That's what I said.
I didn't see that one earlier.
I introed that.
Oh, I didn't see that.
Said it in the intro.
Said in the intro. Got your goat. I mean, what does that mean, like, actually? I'll look it up. It means you got someone, like, riled up. You got someone emotionally. Why is it a goat?
That's my favorite move in a fight, which is the worst move. If I'm arguing with Heather, I liked, or anybody I've ever dated, I like going for, like, the fucking thing. Like
the goat?
I like going for the goat.
Going for the goat.
And once I get the goat, I'm satisfied because I'm like, this argument meant nothing to me. But then I'm like, woo, that was hilarious. And then they're so much more angry.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, and I'm angry lost. Now. And I'm like, what do you mean? I was just going for the goat.
You can't go for the goat.
Can't go for the goat in a fight. I've had arguments with Heather so many times where I get the goat and then she gets angry and I'm like, I don't care about any of this. I don't care at all. And then that makes them more angry.
They're like, well, I do. I'm trying to talk to you. Mm-hmm. You're like, I'm trying to get your goat, bitch.
I'm trying to get your fucking goat. I thought this was. I don't really care about our veggies.
Stupid goat. Call her a goat. That's really what gets my girl's goat is I call her a goat. Mm-hmm. And her goat's been gotten. The exact origin of this phrase has been lost. Some sources speculate this expression comes from horse racing. People believe that placing a goat in a horse's stall the night before the race would calm the horse. I got your goat. Oh, fuck. My horse is all jittery now. He didn't have a night with the goat. The horse fucks the goat before the race.
Oh, you know yeah. What, you know and then saying? They come and they're like, well, I don't really care if I win or...
You were so confused, and then I said the horse fucks the goat, and you're like locked in.
Well, because you had it backwards. I know. You said the origin is that the goat would calm somebody, calm the horse down.
No. So if someone stole or got the goat, it would upset the horse.
Got it. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. I got your goat. Now you're going
to
lose.
I think a jittery horse is what you want, though, to race. One that's like,
No, they trip. Jittery horses fall. I think. You want
a
calm...
Then why would it be an expression to agitate if you put a... Oh, so you're
get
saying...
Their go. You steal their go. You steal the calming presence, and then the horse is all fucked up for the race. And then you're going to have to shoot it, make it into glue. And then you got some glue.
Mm, that's good.
You get the goat, you get some glue. All right, so I got this beach story. Yeah. Why are you holding the mic?
Because what if something happens while I'm smoking that's funny and need to be heard?
And I have
to get
jump on the riff.
Who caught the cord in the fire today? Me. I'm the expert.
The cameras are off. They've never been on.
Please eat the rest of that before the episode's over.
I will. It's got a lot of bites out of it. It's the corner piece in a jigsaw puzzle right now. I gotta finish it.
Yeah.
How we doing on peakage? Oh, we're good.
We're
same
good.
Levels? Yeah, baby.
Yeah, we're good.
All right, so after the party... After the Solas party the next day, I don't stay out that late because I'm going to the beach. Going to the beach, this was what, last Saturday? It was a lovely day. Last, like, time you could go to the beach. So Chris Barnes, Carolyn Banowitz, me and my lady, we all meet at the beach. We go to Rockaway Beach, and it's lovely. It's like 70 to 80, nice breeze. It's, like, hot.
Ooh.
It's hot enough that you want to go in, but not hot enough that you're baking on the beach. And we're just chilling, you know. Caroline Banowitz, a star now.
Yeah.
Hanging out with her, pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty hot.
Okay.
So we're hanging, and we get clout because of her.
Oh, really? People are noticing her?
No one notices her. No. I feel like people are more likely to come over to us. No one did, but it's higher than, the chances are higher than they were.
Yeah.
So we're hanging out at the beach. We're chilling. We're doing a crossword. Caroline's like saying crossword clues, and we're throwing out answers. I don't like crosswords individually, but I think it's a group activity. It's kind of fun.
That's fun. That's a good thing to do.
Yeah, because the clues are like ridiculous in a crossword.
What do they
know?
Think?
It'll be like barnyard, but not the one you're thinking of. You're like, what?
I wasn't thinking of any of them.
None came to mind.
The one I think of, and I don't have any.
I'm two steps behind.
Shit.
I got to think of one, and I got to think of another one.
I got to go rent a lot of Steinbeck books. Steinbeck books.
This podcast is also could also be called "You're an Idiot." Good podcast, Alex.
With Zach Russell.
with Zach Russell. We should have those guys on. Jeff Asmus and Alex Dragovich.
Those guys are very funny.
They're very funny. We should get them in the studio. We got to get a fucking focus right. I'm trying to get guests out the wazoo.
I'm trying to get regular paychecks, but I'm still just a little behind.
Oh,
but
yeah.
They'll be coming in.
Yeah. So what was I talking about? Oh, the beach.
Beach.
So we're at the beach, and then we see a kind of a crowd forming. And there's like a large object that it looked like someone threw maybe like a rugby ball that's like buried in the sand a little bit. It's like in a little sand crater. And then we go a little closer, you know, we see feathers, wings. It's a seagull. Big seagull. Terminally ill seagull. Oh. Like a bad big seagull. It looks like some kid fed it like a tortilla chip or like
a like a Pocky hot chip challenge.
What?
The Pocky hot chip challenge.
What is a Pocky hot chip? That's that. I think I had a stroke. I'm like, you're saying hot pocket?
You are so old.
You don't know Pocky hockey? What is it?
Pocky talkie?
Pocky hot chip?
No, you know what it is. It's the chip.
It makes the gulls
Pocky
explode.
Pocky is, yeah. No, it's the chip that, yeah, they make them.
No, we haven't you heard that, we've all heard, haven't you heard the news that if you feed a seagull a tortilla chip or something, its stomach expands.
I didn't grow up with seagull culture. That's rice for me. Uncooked rice to a pigeon.
Right. Everyone has like a, if you give a bird this, they explode.
Yeah.
What's your formula?
I didn't grow up on the water, kid. Yeah. I grew up in the desert.
We know about rice.
Yeah. We don't know about
rice and
tortilla
pigeons.
Chip for your living on the water birds, for your affluent birds.
Yeah, like I can tell you what you feed an ostrich.
You can tell a lot about someone by the type of birds they saw growing up.
Yeah, I did see a lot of seagulls. I'm a nautical guy.
Yeah, you're a, well,
I'm
I
a
mean,
water
you
lover.
Lived on the water. Dude.
I lived on the water, and then we're at the beach.
Yeah,
I'm back home.
A Pocky, are those chip, the Pocky hot chips that you see on like YouTube and Instagram reels, where it's one chip, and they're like, "Today I'm eating the one chip," and it's like supposed to be the spiciest chip.
Okay,
it's a huge trend.
Okay,
and so that's what I was saying, because a lot of people,
you're looking at YouTube trends.
It's all over the place. All
right.
YouTube, TikTok, I'm up to, look, pal.
Yeah.
Don't be mad at me for keeping up with the
keeping up with the times.
Keeping up with the chips. Okay, so what happened with the seagull? You know what's funny is I'm going to buy you this chip and we're going to have to try it.
Yeah, you seem like you're mentally blocked here on this chip. You're like, I can't believe he hasn't heard of
it. It's just weird that you didn't know about the Pocky hot chip.
The fact that it's Pocky and then the next word starts with an H, I'm like, you mean hockey? That's what I'm stuck on. Pocky hot chip sounds like a child is like trying to learn English.
It sounds kind of like
I want a Pocky hot chip. You fucking kid, you idiot.
It sounds
you
like
want a potato chip.
You know what it sounds like is that
I
like
want hang it.
You know when you find Pokemon is Asian or whatever it is for a pocket monster.
What? Oh yeah.
That's what it sounds like. It sounds like
Japanese.
Yeah,
they're Japanese.
I didn't know, so I said Asian.
That's where all like Asian video game manga culture comes from, is Japan.
Okay.
Any cartoon? Sorry. I don't think I can think of one Chinese cartoon. And there you have it.
Yeah.
I can't think of one.
I don't know if they make cartoons over there.
Yeah. They keep it in-house. It's a lot. Yeah. It's a lot of pro-government stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're at the beach and we see this seagull and it's like, it's struggling. It's like can't really move. Its movements are so like slow and limited. It looks like animatronic.
Mm.
It's like, you know, what's that fucking? It's a seagull after all. That's what I was trying to say. Like it's a small world. It's like,
yeah. Ugh. And people are crowded.
I'm a dying bird.
People are crowded around it.
People are crowded. I mean, it's the beach. If you go to the beach and there's like a thing happening, whatever it is, like dolphins or like a corpse, you'll look at a corpse on the beach, right?
Yeah, but
wouldn't you go up?
No.
What?
Mm-mm.
Not even to see what it was.
I would see, but I'd be like, ah, and I would leave immediately.
Oh,
be like,
sure.
Ah, fuck.
Okay. No, there's people, you know, the old people on their walks, they're coming around, they're like, oh, dead bird, cool, you know? People are at the beach, you're not doing anything at the beach.
Mm-hmm.
You're just like, I brought my book and my family, and they're both kind of boring me.
Yeah.
I'll go check out this dead bird.
What's dead bird about?
It's dead bird time.
Yeah.
It's cool, it's like an event on the beach.
Are you talking to people?
How long has it been here? What's it like? What do you think its chances are? There's this...
What do you think its chances are?
There's a girl who was there, this girl wearing Vans on the beach, black jeans, Vans... You know, what's she doing on the beach?
What are you doing here?
What's she
doing
on the
beach? That's the worst out of place moment. What are you doing on the beach,
lady?
Yeah,
but she also found someone who doesn't belong here, a dying bird. So she goes over to it. She finds a friend. And
oh, she's sitting near it?
Dude.
Boo.
Dude, no. There's people bending over, petting the seagull. Petting it. It's going to be okay. Calming the seagull. It's like, this is COVID-20. This is human avian contact.
Yeah.
White girls at Rockaway Beach.
This is bird pox.
Yeah,
gold
it's coming.
Cox.
This is, I mean, we're going to have to stop basic bitch hate pretty soon.
Yeah. Because
there's going to be a lot of stereotypes about white girls sympathetic to seagulls come the next pandemic. That's what I think.
Did any of your ladies go up and pet it?
Okay, so my lady.
I knew it.
Listen, no petting. There was no petting. But my lady is a vegan. She's sympathetic to the plight of a dying animal. So she's looking at it. She's sad. I wanted so bad, like, as everyone's crowding around, what should we do? What do you think we should do? I wanted so bad to just go up, take its neck.
I was picturing somebody.
Everybody go back about your day.
Come on, beach ball, crosswords.
That would be the more humane thing.
Of course, kill it instantly.
I could make an argument for walking up. If I walked up to the seagull with a flip-flop, curb stomped it, I could make an argument that that was the humane thing to do.
Yeah, I'm better than all you. You guys wanted to watch it die.
Yeah.
Huh? It's disgusting.
You see a soldier on the battlefield, you give him a shotgun with the trigger positioned at his toe so he can aim it at himself. And that's what they used to do. The muskets were so long. You had to put see a little history, splicing a little history in. You had to. The muskets were so long. You had to have it see like your fucking big toe would pull the trigger.
That's what somebody else would give you one of those.
Or well, you would or do you it could yourself. Do it to yourself. Dude. You could position it like that. But you could be like, could you just? So man, Charles is lost in a moment right here. What are you thinking about? What's on your mind?
Thinking about being that guy.
Oh yeah, okay. I didn't know if you were onto the seagull. Or what was going on?
No, I wish somebody with a Desert Eagle. This is why we should all have guns, by the way.
I agree.
This is the moral of the story.
Yeah.
Should all carry, just in case you see a dying seagull.
It's the only way to stop a dying seagull. It's a good guy with a gun.
Guns stop pain.
Yeah, that's true. I hated that they touched it.
Oh, they touched it. You said they didn't touch it.
No.
So she went up and what was she doing?
My lady didn't touch it.
Oh, people
were touching it. Uh-huh. I'm in the ocean. This girl with the Vans and the black jeans and, you know, there's My Chemical Romance coming out of her jacket. She's got little headphones in. She forgot to turn off.
Yeah.
She spends the whole beach day tending to this bird. Just like looking at it, talking to people about it, updating them on the status of the bird.
Oh, God.
How it's looking,
how
it's doing.
How old is this girl?
She looked young, 20s. It's like I'm like, go fuck it, enjoy the beach. It's September. There's not going to be many
gotta
days
let it,
left.
Yeah, let go. And
she wasn't going in the water.
Yeah, that's, you know, true. What I mean? This is her thing to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to sit with somebody like me.
Right.
You're dying on the outside, I'm dying on the inside.
That's right.
We're not okay.
She's whispering to the seagull, I cut myself today. Yeah. I know what you're going
seagull's
through.
Seagull's like.
Seagull's like, I'm fucking dying. I'm
dying over here.
You dramatic.
I'm fucking dying over here. Dying.
Somebody give me some water.
Somebody give me some.
This was Brooklyn. This was Rockaway Beach. The seagull's like, can somebody put me out of my fucking
work union 40 years. I'm dying on the beach. Is this how they do me?
It did look like it was like fed a bag of rice or something. Or like fireworks or like a Pepto-Bismol.
Ooh, a Mentol and a Coke.
A Mentol and a Coke. Yeah, we were trying to get there. Menthol and a Coke and a Pepto.
A Pepto and a Moke. I heard you.
A Pepto and
we'd
a choke.
Your AIDS.
Yeah, we'd be pretty good. We show
just
our work.
Sound.
We show our work. Yeah. Not a lot of comics show their
Geppetto
work.
Pepto and a bloke. And I'm like,
yeah, and they were like, Mento and Coke. And a lot of people would go directly there. But we want to show you guys how the sausage is made.
Yeah.
It kind of adds to the appreciation.
Definitely keeps your attention. We figure it out live.
Yeah. The live shows are going to be a lot of math.
Crazy.
A lot of arithmetic
we're
going
like
on.
Sinbad right there.
Yeah. He is like that. He builds the bit. He does not hide one thought from you. The thoughts are all coming at you.
It's so funny that
every
does that.
Thought I have, my name's Sinbad. I'm actually good.
Yeah.
I thought he was bad. I'm like, his name's Sinbad.
Him and Earthquake are like the two chosen ones that can be comedians. You ever hear Earthquake talk about it too?
Talk about what?
His jokes?
No. Oh, about how they'll just talk to
he's
their
just
friends.
Like, I just go on stage.
And they go up and say the same thing.
He's like, I don't know what I'm going to say, but I know I'm going to get off in 7 minutes when he was younger.
Yeah.
He'd be like, I don't know what I'm going to say, but
when
I
when he was nothing but a tremor.
Yeah. And then, nothing but a, yeah, that's funny. And then they're the ones that actually, that was the right thing to do.
Yeah.
Is to not prepare.
Just go up.
Just go on there,
just
man.
Talk.
Just come on, do it. And they kill.
Yeah. So, yeah, dude, I almost called the CDC. I mean, I was concerned.
I would have done that. I would have looked for an arrow.
Death is upon it.
Yeah.
Death is upon this bird. It looks contagious. Like, you know what I mean? Something's dying. You're like, I don't want to get
too
close.
That girl's having a bad time right now. She definitely contracted what was ever.
Yeah.
Yeah, something happened.
Yeah, wings are sprouting out of her back, and they're not pretty. Mm-mm. They don't start
pretty.
They're
just a little nubs.
They're just
right
little
now.
Bony nubs.
Yeah, they're just a little feathery. Yeah. Thank God she's got a hoodie.
She's getting caught on doors.
Yeah.
It's like she can't take her backpack off ever.
But she likes them a little bit. Yes.
You're right. It's because, you know,
I
she's special.
It was different.
Yeah, it's like Twilight.
Yeah.
It's her Twilight.
Yeah, she's going to show them soon.
There's a few things on the beach that you can touch, because I was thinking about this. I'm like, they were touching the seagull. I'm like, you can't touch that. But there are, you can touch a jellyfish. Dead jellyfish, living jellyfish.
on the top.
Yeah, if you touch it on the stinger, no one's going to call you gross. They're just going to think you're an idiot.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, no one's going to think you're diseased.
That's true.
Doesn't have a brain, doesn't have an anus.
Yeah, you can
no
kiss
risk.
A jellyfish.
Yeah, you could kiss a jellyfish. Mm-hmm. You could lick a jellyfish.
Yeah.
Put it on a sandwich, peanut butter jellyfish. Didn't they have that in SpongeBob? They ate, like, sandwiches, and then they got, like, fucked up on, like, jellyfish.
I don't know if they got fucked. Did they get fucked up?
I watched the Newgrounds version. Ah. Yeah, I think they fucked the jellyfish.
Just jellyfish or pussy? Yeah, the jellyfish did have, like, jam. What a good
jellyfish
show.
Jam. They yeah. They farmed. Like yeah. But I think if you ate too much of the jam, you went a little jam crazy.
You maybe, jam yeah, it. Maybe. Maybe I missed those eps.
Yeah, I don't know. It could have been in the third act of the episode. Oh, you can touch. You can't touch a dead fish. You can touch a live fish. What do you think about that? Right? Dead maggots. Well, you don't want to do that.
Yeah, you don't want to
grow up with any of this. You in Arizona, you could touch a desert bone if it's picked clean. You could pick up a bone, right? If you see a rib cage out there.
I'm
right. Little what are those things? Little longhorn, little Texas longhorn like out in the sand.
Sure.
You pick that up, hammer toss it, see how far you can go.
Yeah. My favorite pastime with the boys growing up.
Hammer tossing.
I mean, Arizona is fucking littered with rib cages.
Right?
It's like the bottom of the Lion King level when they go to the hyenas.
Yeah,
live.
You grew up in like a Huatepel cave, right?
Yeah. I grew up worshiping the sun god.
Right.
And every week we had defeated a new hyena. So there'd always be a ribcage around in the desert for us to throw as far as we could.
Yeah, you went to Sioux Elementary, right?
Mm-hmm.
Comanche Tech. Comanche Technical Institute. You were saying that you were the only community college that was built on an Indian reservation.
Yeah, but it's not like...
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
It's not like I'm going in there and they're like, ID, and I'm like... Bah, 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 and they're like...
You had to go wow, wow, wow.
I didn't know, you know. What was I going to say?
You could have thrown in a how.
I told you I dropped out of community college like three times, but I would always sign up for the same teachers. So
wow,
the
class like,
would be the same.
This land is cursed.
Yeah.
This kid's haunting me.
Every other summer, the teacher would be like, hi.
Hello.
And then be like,
I'm trying again.
Yeah.
I'm going for it. I'm trying to get really big and learn a lot.
Yeah, I'm trying to be me.
Yeah.
Hopefully, I still remember the answers from last year. I used to have a joke about that. A teacher would be like...
Be the same course, same teacher?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
No, it would give me a better chance because it'd be fresh in my head.
Dude, it's like you're replaying a video game level. Mm-hmm. You're like, well, let me go get some XP, do some side quests.
Yeah. See if I make it all the way this time.
Yeah.
See if I get a new save progress.
Oh, my God, dude.
I have to try again next year. I had one joke.
I've never heard of an approach to school that's so stupid.
I just did. That's a smart idea.
It's a waste of time.
No, I didn't do it on purpose. I would get to a point in the year when I'd be like, fuck this. Why am I going to college? I'm wasting my time. Then I would stop showing up. And then I'd be like, what am I doing? You got to go to college. And then I would re-enroll, and I'd be like, let me take the same classes so I'll still remember and get better grades.
And how many times did you do this? How many
like
cycles?
Three.
Okay.
That's like...
And you didn't end up graduating?
No, I did.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, never mind.
So, it was all just right,
so
like,
you made it. For some reason, I thought because you just told me you dropped out three times, I assume you just didn't graduate.
No, I graduated eventually. I got two associates.
Oh,
two
yeah?
associate's degrees. My big Jared has this.
You had a BOGO deal by then.
Yeah,
they're
I did.
Like,
I got
if you
two
pay for three semesters, we'll
I used
give
to have a joke
degree.
About it. Was I had the classic one. Got two associates. Spent all day rubbing them together, hoping they'd turn into a bachelor's.
That's funny.
That's classic. I saw Jared Schwartz do it like the first week I moved here, and I was like, that genius.
Okay, so touching dead animals. What do you experience death in the desert? What's that look like? It's
I
not
mean,
bones?
I didn't grow up in the desert. I grew up in
Well,
the
every time I talk about the sea, you act like you did. You
well,
go,
I, mean,
oh,
I
don't know all
yeah,
about this. H2O.
Yeah, I mean, that's a crazy
H2O
lifestyle to me.
H2O, back up.
I mean, I grew up in the...
Cut that.
I drive by the desert. Like this, it's like a valley.
Yeah, Valley of Death.
I grew up in the suburbs, but yeah, you're in the desert. But it's not like you're just like... I mean, there's coyotes in neighborhoods and stuff. But
okay.
It's like a civilized...
So you ever see a dead coyote?
No.
I mean, I'm seeing a dead deer on the road. You got to give me something. A fucking turtle somebody splattered?
I don't have... We didn't
a
have
rabbit,
deer.
A rabbit, a jackrabbit, a jackal?
I've seen dead rabbits.
Chupacabra?
Yeah.
Seen dead rabbits?
A lot of dead rabs.
Really?
And not the good kind.
Dead a rabbits.
Yeah, I wouldn't touch a dead rabbit.
Exactly. Well, you can't touch a dead man.
I mean...
I'm trying to think of things you could touch.
That are dead?
That are dead. I think maybe a dolphin. Just like, I wonder what it... Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I don't have to pay at SeaWorld. Now I know what it feels like to swim with the... You get in there. You're just like, come on, man. Have you swam with dolphins before? in a sense.
Yeah.
I did a kind of a sea burial with one. Unassisted. He was dead when I got in there.
I knew what he wanted.
Yeah.
I knew
what
he wanted.
He wanted to be returned.
Yeah. He was immediately eaten by a whale. And that is...
The circle of life.
Killer whales are insane.
Oh, yeah.
I saw a TikTok of their one of their strategies. They filmed, you know...
Hunting strategy?
I was blown away.
What's going on?
There was a seal on a big sheet of ice. Like a big sheet of ice.
Yeah.
That was like attached. So three of them... Go under the big sheet of ice. Boom.
Yeah. Double bounce him.
Double bounce him. Crack the ice. And then, so like now the seal is just on like, there's like a little bit of water. He's still like, hey, I could hop to the fucking big sheet of ice.
I'm not dead yet.
Then the whales get to one side of that little crack, of the big crack piece it was on.
Yeah.
Right? So now, here are the pieces. They're just separated a little bit. Whales come right here. Start swimming it.
Okay.
Separating the seal.
Whoa.
And then they turn back around, pans over the seal's eye, zoom in. It's going,
I'm fucked.
And then they go, turn back around, boom, one more bump. Now the seal's on just enough to keep it. It's flipping. It's got to have perfect balance.
The water.
This
yeah.
seal better have some good core stability right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, Cirque du Soleil.
Yeah. And then two whales break off. The middle whale turns back around and goes, boom. Drowns it.
Damn.
Yeah.
And they wonder why, like, a trainer got drowned. It's like, yeah, that's what these animals have learned to do over millions of years.
Yeah. Why do we...
They drown. That's how they stay alive.
Yeah, let's find the non-killer whale.
Yeah. Yeah. The pacifist whale.
Is that a killer whale? Yeah, we should put that in a cage with people.
No, that's just a wrong place, wrong time whale. He's not a killer. He killed someone.
Who?
Oh, I'm just saying. Oh. He's not a killer by nature. He's just a wrong place, wrong time. Whale.
Yeah, that's.
I thought it was pretty funny. Although,
yeah.
I wonder if they like forgot to feed. You know the guy who got drowned at SeaWorld by the whale, or like a trainer,
yeah.
the girl.
Yeah.
A guy
yeah.
almost got drowned, like very close. Kept dragging him under for like a minute and a half during like a show.
Whoa.
And usher people out. It's crazy. But there's this one woman who did die.
Yeah.
When she got drowned and like dragged under. But what was I gonna say?
Do you think they forgot to feed him?
Oh, yeah. Do you think they forgot to give him lunch that day? And then just the hunger instinct kicked in?
Could've.
Gotta drown. Mm-hmm. I'm hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta drown something.
Yeah. And they
gotta drown this thing. That's how I get food.
And do you think they just sedate
I just
them?
Feel that.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's just how I feel.
Yeah.
I don't, you know, I don't dislike the guy. I'm just
like,
hungry.
It's like that guy that hung out with bears. Idiot.
But one day he went in kind of like, I want to get eaten by a bear.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, dude. He might have gone in being like, I am one with the bears.
He brought his girlfriend.
Yeah. She died too, right?
That, yeah. The bear ate.
What a bad time to hook up with that guy.
Oh, my God. Why would you?
Yeah, he like hangs out with bears, but he's tight. Like, they're chill.
That's a true testament to how much of a chance women give men. You could hang out with bears, and there's still going to be a woman out there that's like, I think I could, like, work with this.
Yeah,
this
I think it's, like, no, it's, like, good for him. Yeah, and it's good like, for us.
It's good for, and I'm going to go, and I'm going to see
the
bears.
Because he has his thing, the bear thing. He hangs out with bears, and then I, you know, I go out, and I have a life.
Yeah, and I, you know.
I never wonder where he is. I know he's with the bears.
He's with the bears, and he's not going to fuck the bears, okay? He's not like Mark.
I was hanging out with rabbits. He's bigger than them. It's different.
That's how she dates? It's what kind of animals do you hang out with?
Oh, they're smaller than you? I'm sorry. It's
I
not going
to
work.
I have to be huge beasts. It's my only...
I only fuck men who hang out with huge beasts.
Huge beasts who can eat them whenever. Yeah. That just really gets me. If you can tame a huge beast...
That's hot. That's God. Like when a girl's like... Because, you know, I'll be like, yeah, I'll do butt stuff. I'll take stuff in my butt. And they'll be like, that's hot.
Yeah.
That's so manly.
Wow.
Yeah. And I'm like, I think it's fucking pretty gay. Yeah.
No, that's like really, that's like the most masculine.
That's so hot. I'm like, I'm telling you, I want a man in my butt.
Yeah, I don't want you to fuck me in the butt. I want
no,
I
mean, I'll take whatever in the butt. I'd prefer a lady to fuck me in the butt,
yeah,
honestly.
Sure. Yeah, I bet that's a little softer than a guy.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, because
yeah,
a guy can really feel it and thrust.
Yeah, guy, I'm like, what's the...
Lady's been dancing with her
hips. Prickly Wigglies back here.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that's cute.
You know, our Velcro hair gets tangled. It's like two kids with braces kissing each other. It's like, if two gay Greek guys fuck, they're just going to have to go to the hospital attached. It's like, the dick is out. But
Chinese finger trap.
Yeah. We'll
pull them closer together and then expand. Yeah.
An Aristotle hairnet.
Do you guys want white sauce? There's already a lot of it down here.
We'll put some red sauce to neutralize. Anyway, so Let's get back to the seagull, because we're not even a quarter of the way done.
Oh, wow.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Jesus.
You know, it's always fun. I got 30 more minutes up here,
you
guys.
You really got my goat.
I got your goat.
I was like...
Killed your goat.
Man, my horse is anxious. I'll tell you that.
That's a good response to someone who got your goat. Whew. Well, let me tell you, that explains why my horse is so anxious. They're like, what? You don't know.
You're crazy.
IYK. See, we're showing you the math.
IYK.
That was a rough
Y-K.
Draft. YK. YK.
If you don't K, IDK.
I wanted to get IDTS going.
What does that mean?
What do you think it means? Because I'm trying to see how self-explain. Yes! It plays. IDTS. Hey, is Brittany coming tonight? IDTS.
It just sounds too clunky.
Yeah, I know.
ID. D, you can't have it.
D-T-S. S is fine. It's the D and the T. IDK, nice clean dismount. Yeah. IDC, pushing it, but it's still good.
Yeah, you could be like IDC.
IDC.
What's someone really?
That's how I type it.
IDC.
IDC.
Effect.
Yeah, you love the effects. I love you.
Why would you not use an effect?
You introduced me to the effects.
You're a dancer. I feel like you love effects.
I do love effects. I love fireworks. I love sprinklers and sparklers. Yeah. I brought my fog machine. Can you believe no girl wants to dance with me? A sweaty man smells of weed and fog. Can you believe that?
Scene of old Greg. You're in a boat.
I'm in a boat. I'm so wet and I'm in a boat. And nobody wants to fuck
Any
me.
Any ladies want to fuck my ass tonight after we dance?
Can you check your cams?
Check your cams.
Check your cams, kid. And I'll tell you about my lady who didn't pet the seagull.
Sure.
Who didn't start the avian flu part two. You still going?
Yep.
Nice. You want to just hit it and then hit it again? Is that your spot? There you go. Very passive-aggressive way to
is
ask it.
Is that your spot?
Is that your spot?
Oh, that means move.
So did you wash your hands?
Did you say thank you?
Did you brush your teeth? My brother used to wet the toothbrush to trick grandma.
That's very funny.
Yeah, that's pretty silly. He's bad teeth. he skimped on the teeth. All right, so we're at the seagull, and my lady, she's vegan. You know, she has a big heart, bigger ass. I love her butt. It's so nice, and I'm just here to celebrate it. But she is one of the girls. She's holding counsel. She's like, what do we do? What should we do? And she actually becomes a pretty involved player in this whole saga. So I'm getting ready to go into the water with everybody. Let's go in.
Let's leave her.
I leave. Well, I leave the gull people. The sea gull
And she
people.
Is now one of them.
She's become a gull person. They're making plague doctor masks. They're in hushed tones discussing what options are open to the seagull. And I'm going down to the beach. I'm like, where's Molly? Because I look over. She's not with the gull people. They're starting to squawk. They've gone native. And they're turning into gulls. They've got the flu. I'm worried I'm going to get like the death rattle of the gull, breathe it in.
Yeah,
and then just like start getting people's french fries. You know, just turn into a gull man. Gary Gullman. I turned into a great depressed seagull comedian who's 6 feet six and
lives in Harlem,
very Jewish, such a nice guy.
Yeah,
he's great. So I'm going into the water. I got the wabobo. I'm ready to play. You know
what's a wabobo? Okay. Oh yeah, you told me about this.
So it's a combination of like a skipping stone and a ball. So you can skip it on the water if you throw it really hard. But it really separates you as a friend to me by how you can throw the wabobo. Because not everyone can do it. It's like apparently hard. I don't understand.
Wow, you said that like it's always been easy for you.
It has.
You don't give sympathy to anybody with these.
Not with the wabobo. Yep,
it tells
me who you are.
It's apparently hard.
It's evidently difficult. I don't see it.
Evidently.
Chris is good at throwing it. I think you'd be
good.
Well,
he's tall.
Okay. Tall people can't be
He's
good
got
at
long.
Everything. Yeah, but you really
but
gotta
they
like
are.
You gotta ooh, jeez.
You okay?
Might have hurt my Waboba arm.
You got Tommy Wabobas.
I've got Wabobitis. Caroline sucks.
Come on.
Women can't throw the Waboba. And I'm not saying that women can't throw. I am saying they can't throw the Waboba. Mm-hmm. There's something wrong with the double X chromosome. Something's interfering. Their spatial reasoning is off. Their like trajectory. You have to throw it hard. And you have to, like, chuck it at the water at an angle that make sense for it to bounce. Like, you have to throw it like you would a stone.
It's a math thing. That's what
it's a math thing. Yeah. If you're an Asian woman, cancels it out.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can throw the woboba. Mm-hmm. It's yeah.
Did you try giving Caroline like a pie or anything? I don't know.
Oh, just because she's very skinny?
No, no. It's the woman cooking thing.
Oh.
I don't actually. I was trying to go off this.
No,
she's beautiful.
She is beautiful. She's would admit she's very thin, and I'm worried about her. And you just took all the fucking water.
Dude, I offered you water.
And you kept guzzling.
Well, yeah. What am I supposed to do? Save half for you, the guy who doesn't want me?
I did want some.
It's like, well, you should have told me I'll want some later.
We'll be right back, guys. We got to sort some stuff out. No, I'm kidding. Pick it up. So I'm going.
I'm pissing this right now.
I'm playing with the wobob. I'm throwing it with Chris. You know, Caroline throws it. I got to go swim for it.
It's like that. It's like situation. When you do a three-way frisbee and you're like, almost.
Yeah, I have to run now.
Keep your elbow straight, bud.
Well, frisbee's hard. Like, if you don't have sympathy for a Frisbee person, that's fine. Because I can't throw a Frisbee
very well. No, I have sympathy, but I like to play with people who can throw.
Yeah. It's really like a bummer when you play with someone. You're like, ah.
You're like, spend a lot of time running.
Yeah.
This isn't Frisbee as much as it's me intermittently jogging.
Didn't know we were playing Ultimate. Yeah. I'm playing one-man Ultimate over here.
I'm really, this is more of a showcase of my athleticism.
My agility. Yeah. You're throwing line drives.
Yeah.
She's making you cartwheel around the beach.
Yeah, making all they have to do is I'm timing it to when they finish the word what, it closes in their mouth. Meanwhile, they throw it so high that I got to look in the sun to see its trajectory, lose 10% of my vision.
Yeah, and your brain cells. You got to do a lot of computations.
You ever do that where somebody throws and it just goes, you know, and you're like,
Yeah.
I have to run really far. I know that. Okay, so you're throwing the wobba.
So throwing the boat, we're having a good time, and she's stomping off. You know, I see her butt just disappear into the distance. And it's funny to me.
Towards the water or
towards
society?
The beach? Towards like a shack that's a half a mile away.
Wow.
Where some witch doctor lives who's going to steal the beak and wear
the
it
goose
as a necklace.
Doctor, yeah.
So she's stalking away, and it's just a funny juxtaposition because she's, you know, attractive. She's a nice... And she's wearing like a skimpy bathing suit.
Ooh.
So she's like stomping away. And her butt's working. You know what I mean?
That's
I'm like,
awesome.
You're going to save a gull. Save a gull, ride a cowboy. So the lady, so she comes back and, you know, after we have some fun in the sun and she says, okay, someone's coming. And I'm like, who's coming? What do you mean? Someone like a beach janitor? Like a guy with a broom and a bucket?
The beach vet?
Yeah, a guy with a huge vacuum.
A big net. All right. You see him walk towards a restaurant. Oh, no. Is that where they?
And then she goes, no. It's a marine biologist. A marine biologist is going to come to the beach. I'm like, this is what they do? This is the job of a marine biologist is to pick up
dead
birds.
They just have one on deck?
Yeah. This is where I start spinning out of control. I start losing my mind because I'm like, so.
Are you high?
No. No, I'm just on the beach. I had a good not high beach day. It was fun. I'm not actually losing my mind, but like I'm just, you know.
No, I know what you mean.
But like I'm like, this is ridiculous. What are we going to... Because at this point, the seagull is alive. It's struggling. So she's like, a marine biologist is going to come. I'm like, to what end? What's the goal of the marine biologist here? Like, are we going to
revive? Does he have a harpoon?
Are we gonna, no, does he have a little gurney? You got a seagull gurney? What are you going to haul this guy off? Like, are you going to try to repair him? It's a seagull.
Like it's an injured football player?
Yeah. He's
waving
to
everybody.
He's waving as he's hauled off onto Boardwalk A. So he's...
Cut to him and another thing, they got an IV to him. Right. He's on a cycle.
Yeah, I'm like, what are we going to do? Are we going to replace the wing with, like, a sail? like a prosthetic, like sail wing.
Give him a pig's heart.
He has to go through PT. He has to go through like months. Like, who's that being billed back to? The sea creatures, they're not going to pay. You're going to have to like nurse the seagull back to health only to release it back onto the beach where it's just bugging people for chips until this happens again.
Yeah, we don't need
we
them.
Hate seagulls. Mm-hmm. But the fact that it was dying, people were like, oh my God, it can't be alone now. It needs our help. And so this marine biologist comes over and he's. Sunglasses, t-shirt, shorts, no gloves. A marine biologist, you know. A marine biologist. No,
how old is this guy?
No, I don't know. Probably like early 30s. No like scientific equipment, you know. No measuring beakers, no
no measuring beakers.
No, he doesn't
have microscopes,
no xylophones, no magnifying glasses,
no pots or pans.
Nothing to prove to me he's a man of science. Uh-huh. He doesn't have a map, he doesn't have a globe.
No garlic, no cross.
No garlic, no cross. How's he gonna save this thing? If it's not God and it's not with science, how's he gonna save this thing? So
if this bird gets saved, I swear to God, you're going to blow my mind.
He walks over. Let me tell you, he's not getting saved. He walks over, looks at it. He's like, it's a dead bird. So he picks it up. He doesn't pick it up so much as he bends over and cradles it as one would if you were running towards an end zone. He picks it up like a football.
This is a big guy, though. You said the bird was
big. Big bird. I'm talking Thanksgiving turkey. If this fell on the dog, it would kill him.
Okay, and this guy.
And this guy, that's oof. And they walk off
was
into
this a
the
big
sunset.
Guy? What do you?
He was, you know, it's not like it's not an impossible to pick up bird. It's a big seagull.
Okay.
But it's max, and it's got bird bones.
It's got hollow
little bird bones.
You're right, I forgot about that.
So it's big, but it's not dense.
Got it.
So
okay.
He picks it up, light as it is, like a piece of IKEA furniture. It's held together with pegs and rigor mortis. And he walks off into the sunset, just like they're two buddies going to a movie. I mean, he's like, come on, buddy. And that's how it ends. He just walks off bare hand, bare arm, like his whole arm is engulfing the seagull. And before he walks off, he's telling us, I'm like, what are you going to do? Molly was also asking, like, so what's the, you
know. What's the process?
Yeah.
Did we contact its loved ones?
Or right.
Did we?
Can I look over the letter? I just want to make sure you're being sympathetic enough to the family.
Where in his will am I? Do I get all the.
Will I am in there? Will I am in there? So he's like, yeah, we're probably going to do an autopsy, toxicology report. I'm like, this is what we're spending money on?
Nice. This is
seagull toxicology? I get it, because now you can like see what's going on in the environment. But it was funny to me. I'm like, oh, you're going to dig into this bird.
Yeah, you're going
to
kill it, and then you're going to do the toxicology.
You're going to go home. I mean, it was dead.
Oh, it was dead now.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. So he's walking off with the bird. He looks at it. He's like, this is a dead bird.
Oh, I thought it was still alive but in pain.
No. Right when he got there, it was dead. It wasn't moving anymore.
Oh.
Yeah, it had died. So he picks up a just dead bird, cradles it, walks off. I picture them like a montage of their friendship after that, of just like going to a movie. They put sunglasses on the bird.
Yeah, Ray-Bans.
Yeah, so he can get in.
Yeah.
They watch Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah.
It's kind of intense, but doesn't affect the bird.
They do go-karts.
He's dead. They do go-karts.
He's in the passenger.
Bumper cars. He flies out of the car when he bumps him.
His mouth opens just because things are just going in his mouth.
As the day progresses, it gets just more mangled. And it's just
this guy
gross.
Has a problem.
He's got a big problem. We were joking. We're like, what if that guy walks away with the bird? And then 10 minutes later, a guy comes up. He's like, hey, I'm the marine biologist. And we're like, no. He's like, wait, was someone here before? Sunglasses, shorts? Fuck.
Rick.
He does this all the time. He fucks the birds.
Did he have anything on him that looked like he would be a marine biologist? Think
a
about
telescope,
it.
Telescope.
Garlic.
Cross.
Anything.
A net.
You saw none of those and
flippers.
You just believed him.
Did he have flippers?
Come
marine.
On.
Marine.
Wetsuit.
Floaties.
Glasses.
Goggles.
Come on.
If the goggles aren't around the neck, it's not a marine biologist.
Beaker full of lime green fizzy thing.
I was like, I was so surprised that like this is the job of a marine biologist.
Mm-hmm.
Like this is what you do. If you apply to be a marine biologist, they're like picking up carcasses from the beach.
Yeah, you're just getting some sand kill duty like you committed a crime.
Yeah.
Like you're like, that's your, you're getting community service.
Yeah, you're getting community service.
Like.
Right.
You need to go back apart and open up a seagull.
Yeah, I think he would have if there weren't as many people around, just gotten out the pokey stick and put it in the bucket and keep moving.
Yeah, eat its liver like Liver King says.
What?
Liver is like supposed to be an organ that's good for muscle growth.
I was doing a community service riff. You're eating livers.
He cuts it open and he puts the liver in it because that's the
craze.
Just
like you
now.
Do in community service.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're not cutting an animal open in community service either.
Yeah, but you're picking them up with pokey things.
Oh, yeah.
Picking
it
up with the pokey thing.
Puts it in a pail.
Why give, I mean, you know, I'm all for rehabilitation and not putting people in jail, but why give a recent criminal a weapon? You're like, yeah, just like go around, walk on the highway with this spear.
Yeah, I know.
You know, if someone makes you mad. Well, guy didn't give me any money. I'm also panhandling. It must be more effective to panhandle when you're also picking up trash. You're like, do you have a dollar? Are you sure? It's at their neck. Okay.
Yeah, you
try to roll the window up, but you block it with the spear. Now you're just putting like empty Coke cans in this guy's car. He's like, stop. It's rolling under my brakes.
It's
I can't
I
stop.
Yeah. What?
Yeah, dude. So that's the job of a marine biologist. Wow. If you apply to be one on like a website.
It sounds enticing.
Yeah, it sounds fun.
Did I tell you about this?
You get to wear shorts. You get to be on the beach.
That's pretty cool.
You look pretty tan.
Yeah, you got to be hot a little bit. Like getting tan, you're out on the beach.
That's better than a lifeguard. Because you get to be in the shade. You get to be in the sun when you want to.
No one really needs you.
You get to be with hang out with animals.
And how often is someone like, we need a marine, is there a marine biologist on the plane?
Right.
Never.
Yeah.
You never need one. All the marine biologists that I knew in Arizona became like videographers. Like they chose another path. They're like, this isn't working out. I knew some comedians.
You knew a lot of marine biologists?
Not in Arizona. I mean, there was a couple.
You said all the marine biologists.
Like two.
Let's play the tape. All the
probably
dozens.
Not recording.
Yeah, probably.
So
that was the seagull story. That's
a good seagull story.
I mean, that's what I got.
I had some things that I have written down. I mean, my last week was really just training at this job. And it was so funny because I was so grateful. This is my first corporate job.
Yeah.
And I was also working.
How is that?
Well, so far it's just training. So I don't really know.
How is that? I mean, you do know. That's part of it.
I'm just stuck at a desk watching a bunch of videos all day. It's just like you go into a Zoom room and then you wait for somebody in a different department to come online and be like, all right, here's this hour slideshow. And so boring.
Yeah.
I mean, I was so happy to get the job because I was doing like manual labor jobs for a while. And I'm like, I'm so grateful. And it is going to change my whole life.
That's good.
But as soon as the fucking first day started, I was like, this job sucks. I'm a cog. Fuck this place. Like, I have no sense of how happy I should be for it. But
you'll get there.
You're
out of training.
Yeah. We start tomorrow. So I got to go home and cram because I did not pay attention in the training.
You got to do a test.
Yeah, there's been
like
tests
be
and things like that. I think it'll just be fine. I hope. I think it'll be fine. But I got to look at the website today. But I remember, I don't know if you've ever worked with this. I was working with a temp agency,
uh-huh.
And I was trying to get like a corporate job. I was like, just make me a receptionist. I can do that. And since I didn't have, when you don't have any corporate experience, they treat you like you're the dumbest. Every job that the temp agency would send to me, they're like, do you want to work in the mailroom and lick all the envelopes closed? And I was like, I would, but I don't know how to read. So
they're like, we need you for your saliva.
Yeah,
it's mainly how you're valuable to us.
Do you
you're cheaper than a machine, than a licking machine. We can pay you less than we pay the licking machine.
You have lower self-esteem than a licking machine, which is a great metaphor.
It's a good roast.
That's a good, this kid's got lower self-esteem than a licking machine. Then they get another email like, do you want to ring the bell at lunchtime? I'm like, I'd love to do that.
With your fucking dumb head?
Yeah.
You want to? That's cheaper than just buying a replacement bell.
Yeah.
This is having your...
This Charles guy will do anything.
Hard head slam against bronze.
You know, this is better than my last job, falling around the horses in Central Park, opening my mouth and waiting for them to piss. You know, to keep the streets clean. You know.
The best solution's prevention. And that's what Charles offers. The streets don't even get wet when Charles is on the job.
Charles is a gullet. They call him the gull of the street. Street gull.
They call him the pelican.
They call him seagull.
Seagull.
Or beagle.
Oh, Steven Seagull.
No. So I finally, it really is all about who you know. Because this lady, my temp agency people, I was like, hey, I don't want to do any of these jobs. These are really, and you know what was funny? Is
all caps.
Would,
hey.
Hey. I don't want to do any of this. And I would be like, and they'd be like, they knew that I was a mover, and they'd send me a job.
Like you're like, a big dumb lunk.
Yeah, they'd send me a job that was moving, but in a different description.
Oh, cool.
They'd be like, do you want to find a new journey for the furniture in this office to come to a new destination in another office?
Do you want to guide the furniture?
Yeah,
up six flights?
There's a big merger happening. From the second and eighth floor. Yeah. If you could combine those companies together, buy their couches.
Be a part of the synthesis.
And I'd be like,
hey. Floor eight and floor two. No elevator, sorry.
Just you.
Uh-huh.
And I would email and I'd be like, hey, I don't want to do these. And they would always email me back, can you explain why you wouldn't want to do this? I'd be like, because it's moving and I'm trying to get out of this.
We have you listed in our directory as Egyptian slave boy. Is that not right?
Come on.
Do you need to update your information?
We got a lot of big salt cubes I need to get downtown.
So
you need to, come on. How's the sodium? How's the people in FIDI going to get sodium in their diets without you?
Without,
we need
without
you to
Charles
feed the thinkers.
A boulder of salt to his back.
Two of them.
Tugging it.
Like a strong man pulling a fire truck?
Yeah, like one of those trolls in Lord of the Rings that just carry the battering rams. It's a, you have a harness around you.
I'm on the BQE. People are like,
it's digging into your flesh.
I have my own lane. I am resilient, Charles, if nothing else.
Charles only. It's in red.
Oh, is it between, it's a Friday between 10 and, oh, there he is. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
I never
gotta,
see him.
You can't park there. That's Charles only entrance.
Come on, he's on 15. He won't be here for 3 weeks. Scooters are doing jumps off the cubes.
Yeah, the bike messengers.
People are spray painting it.
Yeah.
Hey.
I've really thought about, especially when there's a van with a ladder on the end of it, holding on on my bike and just getting torn to pieces.
Yeah, I think you might die at the
I
end of
I
that.
I think I would die.
I think you might die.
But it'd be a hell of a ride.
I'm saying he would sketch.
Well, he's in a better place now.
Maybe that's what did it, was all those fumes.
All the skitching.
Right behind a bus. That big black
yeah,
box.
Yeah, he was down Skitchstrom.
That was wild to see.
Woo!
So now I
about?
Have the corporate. Well,
oh, the corporate job. Wait.
Well, then I would tell the temp agency.
Oh, all
like,
of the shitty jobs they were pitching.
Yeah, so they
you.
Would send me these things, and I'd be like, oh, my.
Yeah.
And then I'd be like, hey, I'm looking for a corporate. I don't know how many times I need to say this.
Right.
Like, just put me front desk.
Yeah.
And
like you
like,
want to be a front desk? We can make you a front desk.
Anything. Yeah, I could be a.
Yeah, you could lean over and people
can
put stuff
their
on you.
Computer on me.
Yeah, you want to be a standing desk?
We see you as a dinosaur in the Flintstones. You kind of just are an appliance.
Yeah, you're a pedicab.
Yeah. Where to? I'm naked.
Yeah, you have to be naked. They tug on your dick. That's how you like adjust the height. Sorry, you want to hire?
On a horse, you hit its hips.
Right,
they do to me.
Like smack your balls. And then you're like, oh, yep.
Nice, this is a good speed.
Like, you want me to cool down your tea?
Yeah.
He's an all-in-one service boy. Yeah. So you finally got this corporate job, which is great. I've been in the corporate world for 6 years, so I know about training, orientations.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Welcome. Did you never want one?
No, I just thought that I just knew it was easy to get into the service. It was just so much easier to get a restaurant job right out of community
And then
college.
You just stayed in that.
You just stayed. Well, I also thought was like, well, I get off at 2.
Yeah,
and
but
like,
where do you get off? 2?
If you work a breakfast
boy.
Job, you're off
breakfast
at 2, so
boy.
Then you're like, okay, cool, I can just get used to waking up early, and then I can do whatever I want.
Yeah.
So, but now Long it's board. Like I figured out. Now it's so much better to just wake up and be at a computer, just like, just in your boxers. Mm-hmm. And
that's true. You don't have to like, hello,
yeah,
how are you doing today?
Yeah, you don't have to be like a complete like,
oh, Jim, good, yeah, thanks for coming back.
Good to see you. Yeah, it's 6 a.m.
Yeah. People the regular?
Yeah, people would come in every day with, like, strict orders, too, and you're just like, no.
Yeah.
But, so I'm in the corporate job. I turned 30. I saw.
They're like, dance for me.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
That's an order.
What else happened?
The corporate, the training. So you got tests? They're testing your wisdom, your knowledge?
No, yeah, but it's like, I found out if you fail the test, it just shows you the answers, and I take a picture of it and re-enroll in the same class again, you know. A classic.
Rinse and repeat.
A Chucky class.
Learn, forget, repeat.
Yeah.
Learn, forget, fail, improve.
It
repeat.
Sucks when you are on the second time around and you fail the second time. Then the teachers, because I know my Algebra 3 teacher just gave me a B. I got a D. I remember I was taking the final the third year in the row and I was like, you know when you get a test and you go, maybe there's something on this. Oh, my God.
It feels like Algebra 5.
This side's crazy.
Yeah. You keep searching for a doable problem. Well, okay, maybe in the
you
page
a different
two.
One? It's hard.
Yeah. Got a black diamond test.
You
guys got a bunch of greens over
you didn't pay attention to at all.
Yeah, you don't know how to use
that
it.
That was a trick in college, too, was saving. You create a program where you put.
Yeah, I never did that.
With the words. You type words.
Yeah, you did that?
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I can't wait for all your degrees to be snatched from you. Scottsdale community's coming for it.
Just like Louis, Lance Armstrong.
Yeah.
Take all my trophies
just
away.
Like Lance Armstrong, yeah.
They found out I've been juicing on the TI-89. Find out my calculator's inflated. Got too much air in it.
He's got an implant. The TI-89 goes directly to his brain.
Yeah. And did we talk about the apple picking dispute after the hike?
No. Oh, we went on a hike, yeah.
We did go on a hike. I turned 30.
Yeah, Charles turned 30 recently.
30.
Corporate job turned 30.
If I didn't get the corporate
job, I
would have.
You're fucking buckling
down. Yeah, I'm ready.
You wouldn't have turned 30? You would have killed yourself?
I would have killed myself if I didn't get the corporate job.
I'm glad you got the corporate job.
Yeah, thank God, because I have the bullet saved for 31.
Okay. And, well, we got to do the podcast for a little longer.
We'll take off.
We got to take off before you take off.
Yeah. The day we made it, I kill myself. Sorry. Rules are rules. I signed a contract with myself, and I'm no quitter.
Rules are rules. It's a pretty funny punchline.
It's funny being
no matter where you put it.
rules are rules. Rules are rules.
In that order.
Yeah. I turned 30. We went on a hike. It was a great. We didn't talk about the hike. I think
we didn't talk about the hike at all. We haven't done a catch up thing. That's why we got to do a catch up.
I turned 30. Yeah, I turned 30. Did we talk about how I saw a psychic through my girlfriend?
No.
My girlfriend saw a psychic that her friend recommended. It's $150 to see this person. All you got to do is you send them a selfie, and then they know everything about you from a selfie. I can know everything about you from looking at a selfie of you. Sure. Let me see your house. Where are you taping this? I feel like you walk into his house. It's just like, you ever go to those Asian restaurants, teppanyaki, where they have the who's been here on the wall?
Like just randos?
Yeah, just people that have
customers.
Been there. Yeah,
I like
yeah,
going
yeah.
restaurants.
I like that. But I feel like that's what his house
we
is.
We like them.
Yeah.
People who came before.
Whoa, those are deaf people seeing that?
No, it's just a guy.
Okay. We like them.
People who came before.
Yeah, we're like people who come on our birthdays.
Yeah.
People come here.
Oh, people have birthdays here. People smile here.
They got koi fish.
They got people look at koi fish here.
Oh my God, is that Adam Sandler? Adam Sandler's been to like every restaurant.
Really? He's always on those?
There's always a picture of Adam. If you go to a restaurant, Adam Sandler's there like, I'm Adam Sandler.
I love this place.
I love this place.
Jeb Bush is also there, but no one ever looks at that
picture. No one cares about Jeb anymore. Please clap. I sent him a selfie. I forgot. So then one day I get high, and I forgot that he was going to call me on that day.
Oh, no.
So I just smoked a lot, and then my phone rings. I'm really high. I'm like, hello? And he goes, hey, it's the psychic. And I was like, oh, my God.
Lucky for you, my third eye's open.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. What'd you say?
Lucky for you, my third eye's open.
Yeah, I'm ready to listen, baby. Tell me my future.
Over the phone.
Yeah.
From a selfie.
Mm-hmm.
And my voice.
I'm sure you got everything about me.
Mm-hmm. It's not going to change after you talk to me.
Yeah.
He thinks you're going to be like a highly successful business person.
No, he didn't go successful. This
no, I know. And then he talks to you and then he's like, oh, I got to make some adjustments. I'll call you back in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
This is not. You're not the guy I thought you were from your selfie. You look much more put together. So what did he say?
He said comedy's not going to work out.
Good.
He said, I have a bad shadow side. And I was like, ooh, what is that?
Like a bad boy?
Yeah. I told him, I go, you know what I said? I tried to bait him into this one. I go, yeah, I do. I have a really bad shadow side. And he goes, yeah, I could tell from the picture. And I go, yeah, what specifically is like shadowy about it? And he's like, you know what it is. And I was like, but what do you know it is? We had a little Mexican standoff. I was like, I'm calling your psychic bluff here, kid. Because I got angry at him because I was like, why do you think standoff's not going to work out? He's like, it's not a real thing. And I was like, yeah, but you're doing a fake thing right now.
Yeah.
You just happen to be in a period of time where you're not getting burned for your fake thing.
You're both just hyperinflated egos trying to make it on your own juice.
Yeah. But he called me out.
Fuck that.
Fuck him.
Glass house.
So that's
can't throw crystal balls in a glass house.
Come on, guy.
Fuck this
can't
guy.
Cast a stone.
What
literally.
Is he wearing? Is he has a hat on, a pointy hat?
He was probably naked.
Oh, you weren't FaceTiming?
I know. We didn't FaceTime.
Okay. He called you from an old rotary that had a crow on it?
Yeah. It's been in his house since 1920.
Right.
It's a crow with a top hat.
It's also his wife.
Open its beak and talk into it. Yeah.
You listen through the asshole.
Can you hear me through the crow? Yeah. He picks the asshole up. Puts it into its ear.
The crow's upside down. You're talking in the beak. Yeah. Listen through the asshole. And it flaps when you have to hang up. You have a limited time.
You have limited. Yeah.
And then
I'm talking to you from the year 1893.
And then the crow shits out a bill and then it flies to your house. That'll be $100.
Here's his Venmo QR code. He's just on its feet.
It's shaved into its belly. So the psychic calls you and he says you're a failure. It's not a real thing.
Yeah, it says I'm not as good with my mom. It says all these things that even if you, I feel like a psychic is supposed to be a little on the positive side. So I was high.
To stay in business.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're not going to go again.
No, I'm not coming back to him. And then my girlfriend, she was excited. She's like, I'll get this for your birthday. And then after the call,
thanks,
I'm
babe.
High and low at the same time. Because this guy just bashed my whole life.
Yeah.
Told me I'm not going to make it as a comic and have a shadow side that's really bad for everything. And then my girlfriend comes in like, so how was it? And I was like, man, I'm kind of sad.
Oh, God.
She's like, how was the psychic? And I was like, said everything's not going to go all right. And then she's like, oh, You know, when someone realizes they were the reason, and then I got to be like, I told you this.
So was she sad because you were sad, or was she sad because it's not going to be all right?
She, well, then did, I, who then did it she cool, believe? I think it's sad because she was so into it and she got such a positive one. And then I, so I now could also be like, this guy's bullshit. And she wants to take my side because she believes in
she
me.
She got a positive read?
Yeah, she got, I mean, Heather's.
I mean, yeah, you send me a picture of Heather, I'm going to be like, this bitch going to be all right.
Yeah, this girl's hot.
Yeah, but.
I don't know why you're nude, but I like it.
I don't know why I got this picture, and yeah. I don't know why Charles sent it to me. Heather, tell him to stop. He keeps sending me your nudes. And they feature him a lot. It's like you in the background naked, but it's mainly him.
I had a buddy offer me to send nudes once. He goes, I am fucking the chick in them. Like, my dick's in them. And I'm like, I don't know if I want to see, like, your penis. Like,
what an offer.
We live together. And I was like, why would you? He's like,
Brendan
you know.
Gay.
What?
Brendan Gay.
No. He did tell me once. He goes, I got a hammer, man. And, like, and I was like,
cool.
It's cool, man. Uh-huh. It's cool.
Like one that you would use to construct a dollhouse.
Yeah.
Fucking bitch hammer.
Little bitch ass hammer. What kind of hammer?
So, so with Heather and the positive read, it's kind of like you guys came out of like a test and she was like, that was so easy.
Yeah.
And you were like, what?
Yeah. I think I'm getting held back. I think I got to move home.
I think I got to repeat this for the third time.
Yeah. And then for my birthday, we don't do anything. I've never really celebrated my birthday. Have you?
Yeah, well, clearly. I mean, you got punished on your birthday.
It's true.
That
That's
wasn't
why
a
I don't
celebration.
Celebrate. No.
That was just that was like a sentence.
Mm-hmm.
You got sentenced.
I got put
How
down.
Did the call end? Fuck you. Hang yeah. up. Click.
You're a bitch and you're not even real. yeah, I just remember he was like, he said some things. The most I got where he was like, if you ever feel like I'm saying something wrong, just say it. And he got me angry enough where I was like, yeah, man, this just isn't it. I was like, you're just wrong on these things. He's like, yeah, I mean, it's, you know, I can be, you know, that's what you believe. That's what you believe. And I'm like,
well, then what is this then, if that's what I believe?
Yeah, if it's what I believe. I'm
if it just depends on what I believe, then why are you here?
Yeah, he looked at a picture of me and he's like, you don't talk to your mom the way you should. And I was like, woo, that's wrong. When he brought in the mom, that's when I was like, woo, buddy.
Uh-huh.
No fake psychic's going to talk bad about my mom and me. And I was like, that's just so wrong. He's like, okay, I can sense you. And I was like, you're just.
I can sense.
Don't tell me I don't talk to my mom the way you think I should. You don't know her.
Right.
And
she's a nightmare.
Yeah. It's lucky I even keep her number. This chick had me licking envelopes until I was 29. I moved out of the house. I was licking all the mail. We're talking like
that's all I knew how to do. That's the only skill I could market.
Yeah.
I've been endorsed on LinkedIn for mail licking 100 times.
I mean.
But only one person's endorsed my Excel skills, and it's the fake account I made.
I gave myself 5 stars. I deserve it.
I gave myself 4 because I need to work harder.
That's true. I am humble.
Oh, yeah.
About my licking.
Yeah.
I need to do that with the lady tonight, I think. Go down for a licking. Anyway, then we went on a
we went on this fun hike. Is that what you were going to say?
Yeah.
Oh, for the birthday. Yeah, yeah, it was fun. I was glad we went on that hike. My lady was struggling in the beginning.
Yeah.
And it's because she is a diabetic, gluten-free vegan because
mm-hmm.
she has celiac. Mm-hmm. She's got some chronic diseases. Wow. You know? So I was proud of her that she pushed through. But in the beginning, we were going uphill. It was a steep incline in the beginning. And people were like, good pace,
mm-hmm.
charging up the
mountain. New York pace up the hill.
New York pace. I'm walking here.
Yeah.
Where's my dollar slice?
Yeah.
I think it's behind this tree. Third tree on the left, that's Joe's.
It's the bodega. Yeah. Joe's Knock pizza. On the bark, it's going to open up.
And it'll sell you weed. Just ask.
Yeah, they all got it.
Yeah, they all got it. You just got to ask. We got a real, me and the lady, just quick sidebar, real anxiety joint from a bodega. I bought one when I was up near Broadway.
I hate those.
And it was funny because we noticed it, both of us. It was the beach day. We hadn't gotten high all day. Really nice day, really nice time, felt connected, good times, chilling, whatever, enjoying each other's company. And then we both smoke a joint on the, just like that, on the roof. And immediately we're both like talking about our relationship. We're talking about like, you know, we have like death anxiety and stuff.
Oh my God.
Me more with the death anxiety. But yeah, and we're like talking about it, but we're talking about it in the way, you ever just like start winging it about discussing your relationship? And then you start going down a path where you're like, oh, this doesn't feel like a good
I kinda like it.
Thing to talk. Yeah, you're a goat getter, though. You know, a goat getter? You get goats. I don't like it. You
I'm
like
ringing
provoking.
The bell.
You're a provocateur.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I would hate to be in a relationship with you.
I'm
you
a great
poke.
Guy, but I want to know the secrets.
I'm sorry.
If
I would
I'm reading
love
your book,
to be in a relationship with you, Charles.
Thanks, man.
Is that what you want?
You would be so lucky.
Like, yeah.
Your goat would be...
My horse would be agitated. Every night from how good I would dick you down. What were you talking about?
Talking about going on the hike. Your lady couldn't
take
it.
Yeah, lady was struggling. Lady was struggling.
What happened? Do you guys have to have a little meeting?
We had
hike?
A little meetup. I mean, you guys, it? We all stopped.
Yeah.
We all stopped. We
look,
knew.
I try not to remember.
That's nice of you. No, she was just like, I really fell for her because she was looking at me.
She was your damaged seagull on the beach.
She was my seagull.
Yeah.
She wanted to keep going. I mean, obviously, you want to keep going.
Of course.
She didn't want this to be happening.
Uh-huh.
But she was like, they're running. They're running up the mountain. And I'm like, it's okay. We can like take a break. It's fine. And once we got to the plateau, everything was fine. And, you know, it was good. But also, we're like, you know, I'm like nervous. This is the first like active thing I've done with her. She's a diabetic.
Yeah, it's
like
scary.
She needs to monitor her sugar. Like, it's, you know, it's just like a pervasive thing whether or not she's exercising. And when you do exercise, you have to set it to a new level because your blood sugars are different. And like, we forgot some food in the car. She has like enough diabetic food. But like, it's weird. We're like, she needs a cookie. And you're like, yeah. Come on. No, it's like she does.
Yeah, you? She does need a cookie.
A cookie.
What's her cookie? What's her favorite cook?
Favorite cook? Tate's. Because she's also gluten-free vegan. But yeah, Tate's are good in the green bags. But you're struggling.
Let's not forget that she was
Let's
struggling.
Not forget she was struggling. No, but I mean.
No, I know what you mean. She sucked. And,
no, she's great. And then she was a real treat like the rest of the time.
No, she killed
No
it.
Issue.
Yeah.
No issue. And it was a hike.
It was
like
a long
a
hike.
Good hike.
Yeah, it was like a 7-mile hike. Nick, Samantha, you, Molly, Heather, and I.
Yeah.
And then they brought their dog that was a badass.
So cool.
We got to this part with water and the dog just was...
I'll put the video on the Patreon. This dog was like romping around.
Yeah. Having a great day
in
the
mud.
Lake.
Yeah.
Really being a dog.
Really being a
dog.
Really
drinking a lot of lake water.
Yeah.
And I was like, I hope that dog...
Found a tennis ball.
Yeah. In the lake.
In the lake. That dog's been manifesting. That knew exactly what it wanted.
Yeah, that dog's psychic was
spot
on.
I'm
going to
get up there. I'm going to find the ball. It's going to be fun. And the path was so cool. It wasn't like... It wasn't a clearly laid out path. It had like painted signs.
Yeah, it was a great...
You're like climbing on rocks.
Nick and Samantha recommended it.
Yeah, you got to go hand over foot, like up on a shelf.
I had those moments with Heather too where she was like, I can't. And I was like,
really?
You'd be the man.
Heather was saying I can't?
Well, when we got to the lake part initially, she had slid on a rock coming to the lake. So then we had to hop a couple of rocks to all get on that landing where we were watching the dog, Nelly. So on her way to that way, she was like, I just slept on a rock. And I was like, it's fine. She's like, I'm fine here. And I was like, you have to be a man.
Babe, come to me.
You'll be okay.
Yeah.
If you fall, grab my hand when you fall.
Yeah.
So I will fall.
And we'll both get hurt. Yeah. Probably more than you would have gotten.
Yeah. Hurt. You would have actually been able to use both hands to land safely.
Yes, but now you're holding mine in a romantic
and we'll
lover's
slide
fall.
Into a dead bush full of spikes in the lake.
We fly into a thicket of thorns.
Of underwater wasps.
A nest of eels in the mud.
A dancing air eel.
A dancing air eagle. Wow.
Eel.
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 Eel. I said eel. I said eel.
Ew. Eels?
You say you. No, I said ill.
Ill. There's an ill coming right at you. It's funny that they are.
It's a lock rack.
Whatever that ill.
It's a lock rack. Ill. That's an lock rack.
Nelly was hurting us at points. Like, Nelly would run, like, circles around us. Like,
fun.
Keeping us in a tight group.
It was fun.
A tight
just
group.
Keeping us in formation.
It was, so, yeah, didn't run away. There was that woman in the beginning who was like, you need to leash your dog.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
You didn't?
No, I would have loved to hear that.
Yeah, Manth, she hates Sam. Manth was walking, which Manth? What's Manth? You know what I mean?
I don't know. That's a guy you meet at summer camp and
I know, but that's what she likes. She likes Manth.
You go, Manth is somebody.
Hello, I'm Manth. I'm from away. Where are you from? He sounds like one of the counselors, the foreign counselers who are like really good at soccer.
Yeah.
You got to play with Manth.
He's really good.
Yeah.
He came here on his
effort. I'll be goaltender.
It's fun, guys, right? He's the best.
It's fun. Shut up.
Absolutely.
It's fun, guys, right?
Right. Good to see you. I can't do an accent.
So, Samantha's walking up front. Nelly's being, you know, sweet, kind dog. And then this woman's like, you got to leash your dog, you know, from a truck. And then we see her dog. And then we see, so she drives up. So she drives ahead of us. We walk up. We meet her as she's getting out of her car with her dog leashed. And then her dog goes, and we're like, oh, you need to leash your dog.
Yeah.
So the leashing is for our dog's protection. Like,
yeah.
It was funny that she was like, oh, yeah, my dog's insane. You but don't I'm need, you need to shame
leash,
you.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's projecting. You need to leash your dog because I didn't train mine.
Yeah.
My dog's a murderer because I lacked the effort to train it. Yeah. So that dog better be on a rope of yours. Yeah. You know how you go on a hike with your dog on leash? That's the fun way to do it with your dog.
Yeah, you don't have a leash dog.
Yeah, on a hike.
Samantha was ready, though. She had like a big belt. Bungee one. She had a bungee belt leash.
Samantha was the Laura Croft of that hike.
Yeah, dude.
She was ready to go.
Yeah, she walked out with a whole sarcophagus made out of gold she found in a cave.
Yeah.
We were really off-road.
Double pistols, too. Double pistols. Saw that.
Uh-huh. Yep. The bridge, the rope bridge gave out, and she jumped to the other side as bats flew out of the cave right in her face. And the skeletons came alive. No, it was a really good hike. I really enjoyed it. It was the perfect amount of difficulty where you were like, where is it? Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. It's
but not
weird.
Like, we're lost.
And it was cool because the going down had that decline part where like you can't help but kind of jog.
Dude.
I love those parts.
Yeah, but the decline is like the most tiring because your muscles have to be engaged so you don't fall.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be kind of crouched.
Yeah, yeah.
You're like, ah.
Yeah, it's fun though to be like, you're looking down, you're navigating.
Peanut butter jelly legs sandwich.
That was so fun.
Jelly legs.
Peanut butter jelly legs.
Yeah, peanut butter jelly legs.
And then we go to a burrito place. We all talked about hanging out together more.
Oh, yeah.
And I hope we do.
Yeah. And, we'll see. I think they like me.
And then they brought up apple picking, and I said I didn't want to go apple picking, which I thought was the popular way.
No.
I thought everybody was like, fuck apple picking.
You got a bunch of girls and guys here with their girls.
That's a pro apple immediately, picking crown. I've never felt so many friends turn on me.
Yeah.
I said, fuck apple picking kind of nonchalantly. Like, I thought everybody's going to be like, yeah, I know, right? Apple picking's for losers. And then I look up from my burrito and everybody's turned their heads. There's a girl in a high chair who did an exorcism twist, beaming her laser hate into my eyes. And I go, oh, I'm sorry. Is that a... Yeah, I hate it. It sounds terrible. And then it was...
You've never been there, right?
My girlfriend turned on me. That's how wrong I was.
Yeah.
I saw Heather immediately wearing a red-colored jersey with everybody else in the restaurant. And I was like, you're supposed to be wearing my colors and numbers, pal.
Right.
If there's anybody on my team, it's you.
Yeah, he's facing
Nelly?
Off.
Nelly's in the car.
Yeah, Nelly has a gun pointed at you.
Yeah.
Not a popular opinion. Well, you've never been.
But I've only heard it sucks.
I mean, it's not great. I mean, a lot of people have jokes about apple picking, but it's nice to be out there in the fall. You know? And all do you like apples?
Yeah.
I like an apple. I love apples. And you can get all different types, and you get it by the bag. I guess I'm pro apple picking is what I'm learning.
How many bags do you get?
You get one bag. You get one bag, and you walk around, and you're like in nature, but you're seeing the different apples, and you're trying to find the good apples. It's kind of like a treasure hunt.
All right.
I realized
what apples did you get?
I like a variety. I like a, you know, Pink Lady, a Jazz, a Honeycrisp, you know, a Fuji. I'm a big Fuji guy. I'll get some Granny Smiths just to round it out.
Yeah.
But there's always talk of a pie. When you go apple picking, but we're going to make a pie.
Yeah.
Let's make a pie.
Isn't that
and
a new
you
joke?
Just like throw, yeah.
You're
and
no
then you just throw out like a bunch of apples and you never make a pie.
You're really kind of just relocating apples from upstate to the trash.
Right, exactly.
It's kind of just
It's an apple. You're going to guide the apples. You're an apple guide.
I'll throw these away at home.
Yeah, you're like, I've done enough manual labor. Okay,
yeah.
I got a corporate job. I'm not picking apples.
Yeah.
That was one of the applications I turned down.
Apple picker for GE.
Why am I working on a Sunday?
I pick the apples for the GE employee's lunch. I'm in the back.
You know the cafeteria? Well, how do you think it gets there?
Yeah.
On my back.
If you look behind, if you open that chef door, there's a pasture.
There's also with apple picking, if you go to like a nice place, there's a lot of other stuff to do. There's like pumpkins that you can buy to carve. I like carving a pumpkin. That's a fun activity.
Yeah, and BLT is going to be back.
The BLT is back soon. I can't wait to go to Subway and order a PLT. I would love it if a fan sent us a video of ordering a PLT at a Subway.
That would be great.
That would be top tier. Top tier engagement.
Top tier gauge.
Top tier, guys. If you want to be top tier in my book...
Send me a video of you ordering a PLT.
At a Quiznos, at any sandwich shop. I'll take it. Oh, apple picking. Yeah, you have pumpkins. You have apple cider donuts, which they're fine. They're
mm-hmm,
good.
Mm-hmm.
You got maize, a corn maze sometimes.
Just a date.
A hedge
it's
maze.
A fun date.
It's a fall-based activities date.
Yeah,
yeah.
Sure.
You can do a lot of different. There's sometimes a petting zoo. You can pay people to pet you.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I
it's
can
fun.
Do that. That's pretty good.
Yeah. You could throw the apples at people if you're really bored. You know, if you go with friends, you're like starting an apple fight.
That's fun. You can throw apples.
Orchard war.
But are you near anybody when you're picking them?
Actually, sometimes it's big. Sometimes you're like, it's also pseudo a hike. It's kind of like a scavenger hunt. You're looking for the right apples. You're looking at the map. You're like, which side of the map are we on?
Okay.
Yeah. It's kind of like a one-level video game where the prize is apples.
Yeah. It's like with your Kirby walking around with a basket.
It's Mario 1-1.
Yeah, okay.
With apples.
Yeah. Okay. I think we're going to end up doing it.
You're probably going to do it.
Yeah, I got a plan. Okay.
You should do it once.
We'll do it once.
Paintball's a good fall.
I love paintball.
Yeah, we should do paintball.
I would do paintball every
day. That's what your goal. That's why you're trying to become rich. That's why you got this corporate
paintball
job,
every day.
To fuel your paintball.
Nobody has a paintball court in there. How come nobody
paintball
has a
paintball court? Oh, in their house? Like Rob Dyrdek might.
Oh, yeah, Rob Dyrdek might.
You're like a rapper or something. Hey, you mean I got a paintball court down here?
That'd be sick.
And it's like you never use it.
Everybody goes tennis.
You're never home.
Yeah.
Tennis.
Everybody goes
basketball.
Tennis, court, basketball.
Basketball.
I love basketball. We should
basketball
play bump
pool.
Out.
What?
But we should all play bump out sometime.
You mean knockout?
Or knockout.
Westerners. What's bump out?
Same thing as knockout. Oh. But I guess you just haven't heard of the other word.
No, I haven't. I assumed it was knockout, but some lame version that you know.
Bump out's great because that means it reminds you can bump somebody's ball.
I like that.
That's fun.
Knockout, you can, sucker punch them.
Oh, okay.
You can knock them out.
That sounds a little more fun.
It is fun.
Yeah.
You can kick, too, if you can hit their head. Only.
Nice. Only head kicks permitted.
Only head
though.
Kicks. Only head kicks. Oh. I know sometimes it's no head kicks. Knockouts
this is
only
head
kicks.
I head kick, and then you lay it up.
Lay it up. Then you miss. You kill a guy, and then you miss a layup.
It lands on his face. Oh.
Closing his eyes.
Fuck you, Jeff.
Yeah, I don't know what else we got. Do you have anything
that
else?
Be.
That might be it.
I have was might high all day, work from home, fall is here, apple picking, turn 30.
Yeah, how are you working from home? Because now you're in the den of filth, you know? You could create a den of filth for yourself.
Well, my apartment's very clean.
Yeah, okay. Well, I am kind of projecting.
Yeah.
But working from home, you know, you have temptations.
Temptations are there. I knew it was going
to
happen.
You got the weed. You got the porn. I got the video games added to it.
I would love to have video games because that's a healthy. I just need to get a book. But yeah, the first
books are good.
The first week or two, I knew I was going to be a victim to my environment because my home is triggering. That's where I will do everything bad. Overeat.
God, 2022 is so lame.
Overbeat. I know. Talking about how all the self-help terms.
It's triggering.
My environment is bad for my habits.
Trying to self-motivate.
I got ripped off yesterday printing flyers.
Yeah.
And then they charged me for color price. And then Santiago caught it. So then it was $76 for black and white. And then I was like, that's a lot. And
that's
like,
a lot.
Yeah, it's the price. And I was like, all right, I guess I'll just fuck myself on this. And then Santiago texted me and I was like, he's like, that seems like a lot. And I was like, it does seem like a lot. I called and I was like, how much is black and white? And they're like 19 cents. And I was like, cool. I just paid $76. And they're like, oh, it was probably on color. And I was like, yeah, I, you know, that's fine. I'll just come and get a refund. They're like, you're going to have to trade us the assets. And I was like, the assets?
You want me to return my comedy flyers?
I was like, the flyers, they're like, yeah, because you printed them in color. And I was like, no, it's black and white. And they're like, you're still going to have to give us over the goods. And I was like, how about I give you my whole asshole, you piece of shit? You want me to? I was like, cool, I'll come in with the product. I'll expedite the assets to your establishment within 1,400 hours. Then I get there and I was like, hey, these are here's the stack. And he's like,
he's like, what the fuck is this shit?
He's like, so we charge assets. Yeah, I was like, these are the goods, dude. Yeah. And I was like, why do you think I brought them in a safe? And
a locked suitcase.
Then I was like, yeah,
handcuffed to my arm.
Yeah. You have to get a little bit of my blood in there to get the password.
I have to chop off my own hand. I swallowed the key.
It's like 127 hours, but I can move. Mm-hmm. Someone's got to cut through my arm.
Yeah. But I can help. I can wiggle it.
And then he was like, yeah, we just left it on color. And I was like, yeah, it's fine. And he's like, yeah, I mean, that's the default. Nobody ever notices it. And I was like, do you just admit you're like ripping people off?
Yeah, that's gross. You think that's cool?
Yeah. Like I was going to be like, hell yeah, man. Yeah, charge people four times as much. That's cool.
I'm a victim of your scheme.
Yeah. But now I've smart enough to know. Actually, my friend was smart enough to notice.
Yeah, can I get in on that action?
Yeah.
How can I help you trick people into overpaying?
I got friends and family that need to print things.
Yeah.
So there's that. And how's your mom?
Damn. And my mom's good. We just talked before the pod.
Your mom your mom does the parent thing where it's like, you know you have to talk to your parents, but you also have to go. But you can't be like, look, I got to go.
I told her. I'm like, you can't give me any side characters.
That
I
was
need
very
only
funny.
Main character stories right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, she was talking to you about a friend.
She was like, well, Sharon. I'm like, I can't do Sharon. You got to give me, like, Corey, my brother, you know, yourself, my cousin. Like, you got to give me some immediate close circle family member stories or like your best friend. It can't be fucking.
I can't be fully paying attention
from
right now.
College, you know. I don't know. Yeah. I don't care. We gotta set up the pod. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm literally lighting my equipment on fire as I'm talking to her.
Yeah,
I threw the external hard drive cord on the table. We got a candle going because every time we come in here, it smells like a donkey's asshole
and a dead seagull.
And a dead seagull. So we got the candle going. I'm flipping wires around. Charles is like, "Hey, whoa, whoa!" There's, you know, melted rubber or plastic in the air now, and it's a whole scene. And I'm trying to tell her about, you know, how the lady's been and everything. And we're talking about, you know, it's funny how she talks to me about the open relationship because I'm telling her all the benefits, and she's like, "Yeah, I mean, that's I like her. It's just the I don't really understand the whole open thing." And so moms have a way. My mom has a good way of compartmentalizing all this and thinking about it in her own definitions. Instead of open or poly or whatever, she's like, "So you're dating. You're just dating. You're dating other people. You're dating. You're dating.
Just say it, Zach.
You're dating.
Say
you know,
that
it's
I'm
not
right.
Well, these labels, what do I mean? Yeah. You're dating. You're dating."
That's what it is.
And I go, "Yeah, you know," and she's like, "Well, do you think you'd ever close off the relationship?" And I'm like, "Well, she's open to being monogamish." And which is a term.
That's a great term.
The ethical slut. It's a defined term.
Monogamish.
Monogamish, which is like, and then I realized I couldn't go any further without explaining the concept of group sex to my mom.
That's hilarious.
So I was like, I'm going to maybe just be like, "Yeah, I mean, we'll see."
Yeah, I do that all the time.
Because monogamish.
Put a cap on it.
Yeah, monogamish. Yeah, let's just fill the tank halfway.
Yeah.
We don't need to give her the full fuel.
We just don't get where we're going.
Yeah, we don't need to go to the full destination.
Yeah, I don't need to get you there, Mom.
We'll pull off to the side of the road and say, "This is where we're going to actually, this is where the beach is."
Yeah.
We're going to set up
here. A
lot
of sand.
We're going to set up here for now.
We're going to have to walk a while.
Oh, so what monogamous actually is you're together and you know, I don't like this term, but play or like are with sexually like other people
together.
Only when you're together.
Okay.
Or if it's like an isolated one night thing. But typically it would be like, yeah, it's you two or like other people with you two is monogamish. But you can't really be like, "Yeah, well, I mean, no, we'd like maybe get married, you know, just hypothetically get married and then, you know, every now and then have like Sandra and Bob over to," wow, those are my aunt and uncle's names. That was really strange. I just thought of a couple. Have, you know, Janice and Joplin over to suck us down. So I don't really want to say that to my mom. But. It's been good. I mean, I do like the open stuff. I think I want to do a bit about it. I should probably try to do a bit because it's fun. It's like, first of all, in a relationship, your partner can't be your only source of support.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't because that's unsustainable. That's codependent. That's not good. You have to have your own lives and your own support system. Mm-hmm. That's not exclusively each other. And so she has her sisters. You know, she has her friends, and then she also has these, like, people who are, like, in between friends and, dating or whatever, but not really. Like, they're friends who have sex sometimes and whatever. Mm-hmm. You have different connections to people. But then she gets to use those people instead of me. Like, if she recently got sad at this documentary about teachers grooming the students, and it was, you know, very sad and stuff, and then she called fucking over. I'm like, "Yeah, good. I'm so happy."
That's
you have
good. Me. Yeah, I got the. You got PTO.
Yeah, call me when
that's
you need some
called.
Dick. I'll head right
paid
over.
Time off, baby.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. It's like Norman's. I got a girlfriend walker.
Yeah,
you know,
cry.
She yeah, it's like she cried. She cried.
It took her a while. But she cried.
Took her a while, but she cried. It's really great. And I do get jealous, but I don't think of myself as a jealous person. So this has tested that a little.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that she's with someone. One time I was going from the Bowery with you, and I thought I was going to hang out with her, and she's like, "Oh no, this other guy's over."
Yeah, that had. I saw you defy. I saw that arrow hit your chest.
Yeah, and I was like, did. "It's fine."
Yeah,
we carry on.
Back off, I'll take you on.
We persist. Keep marching, troops. That was just a lone arrow.
That's when the first time I saw become a friend to an enemy, real quick.
Right. Yeah. You know, how he could
benefit
me, but now he's now he's on the other side.
Yeah.
First he was in the capture of the flag jail. Now he's on the other side facing off.
Yeah, a line was drawn in the ass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a line in the ass.
One more time.
We each get one cheek. So
we split the butthole.
So yeah, that also freaked. Well, I don't need to get into, you know, his stuff, but
that seems like a nice guy. I've seen him appear on the story.
Oh yeah, Yeah. Yeah. You I have. Think so. You have. Yeah.
I sent him a DM.
Huh?
I said, be careful.
Good.
And then I sent him a squirt gun emoji.
That's my boy.
That's my boy, bro. Are you fucking with my boy?
So I was telling my mom about the whole thing. And she's like, maybe I'll bleep his name. I don't know.
Yeah.
Probably bleep his name.
Bleep it.
And she was like, okay, well, that's, I mean, she thought it was funny, but she's like, well, you know, I loved your dad and everything, but he wasn't everything for me. I'm like, of course you have friends, you have whatever. I know you can do that outside of an open relationship, but it's also nice that
I thought she was gonna be like, sexually, he sucked.
I never went outside.
I never tested the waters. I just dealt with his shitty dick.
I white knuckled his shitty dick.
And it only came up to the knuckles. I'll tell you that. That's why it was white. It was cum all over my knuckles, son.
What? Dude, what are you even saying?
Because it's white.
I see. I see. Now, my daddy dicked my mom down good, and she loved him. So, you're really...
That rumor is put to rest.
You're really coming off as a psychic to me right now. You're telling me things about my mom? And her cum knuckles? And her cummed up knuckles? Don't talk about my mom's cum knuckles that way. God, I hope she never listens.
Me neither.
It's too late in the app, though. She would never get
here.
She
wouldn't ever finish.
She would
my
never
dad
finish.
Likes to pretend he listens, then I call his bluff, and he goes, yeah, I like that one part in where you guys are singing, and like there's a guitar, and I'm like, when did we do that in an episode? He's like, you guys always do it in the episodes. And I'm like, do you want to listen to like the intro song? And he's like, ah, I mean, I don't really listen to that much of them. I'm like, you listen to 11 seconds of them by what you're telling me.
Yeah, yeah.
You hear the, and you go, enough. Anyway. You hear Zach's guitar playing, and you go, I can't.
I can't. It's too amateur. It feels like I'm at Guitar Center right now.
Listen to Sweet Child of Mine from an 11-year-old on an acoustic. Okay.
So I was telling her about the open relation stuff, and I don't know. It is just nice that you can your partner can go get other things from other people.
No, that's
great. You can live independent lives. But it is just there is a coming together that you have to do.
Probably makes you stronger.
I like the fact that we don't text all day and that we don't see each other all the time. It's great.
I think that's great for a relationship.
Yeah, because then we actually have
space.
Yeah, you got to have space. You and Heather have good space, though. Because you're out and about.
I'm out. She's also very busy, too.
Yeah.
So it's nice. There's like, we do the heart, like, in between the house. We'll, like, mess around or, like, I'll hug. You know, I'm, like, sweet to her. Sweet to her. I'm sweet to her. Guys, you ever be sweet to her? To your lady? Guys?
You ever be sweet to your lady?
The other day, I was my lady. I can't do it. I was being sweet to her.
If you know, you know.
Very funny
comic.
I did, yes.
All right, guys. I think that's probably going to do it. What time is it? It's 4:30. We got here, probably started recording around 1 or something, took some breaks, you know, we got some stuff.
We got some juice.
We got some juice, guys, and we're happy to get the keep the juice, keep the juice flowing. Yeah. Thanks for listening. We just hit 5,000 downloads.
Pretty cool.
Which is pretty great.
Thanks for listening. We have to do a lot of work on the squeezing to get the juice out, the editing.
Oh, yeah.
Zach does 10,000 times more editing than me, and I appreciate it, but even the little clips...
Grind him to a nub.
Yeah, it does. It does.
But
make
the difficulty with which Charles experiences editing, it's almost as if we do the same amount of work.
Every other day I send a clip to Zach that's like, it's frozen. I hate myself.
Help!
And it's over.
I hear Charles at the edge of a frozen cliff. Help!
Help!
Like, have you tried restarting your cliff?
I never thought of that.
Yeah.
Is it because I'm using the microwave? Every time I edit, I turn on the microwave. No, Charles.
I hit 1 million views, hit enter.
And then I start to edit.
So I'm in the task manager. I'm trying to manage my tasks.
Is it in OneNote, the clip? But no, thanks for listening. It's really been great. Thanks for sharing the clips. We see the insights. Give us another listen.
We see
the insights.
We see what's
going
on.
We know our demo. Keep listening. Subscribe to the pod if you don't already. Please leave a 5-star review, even if it's a one sentence. Great pod, great ep,
good
chemistry.
Period.
Yeah.
Right? Good period, 5 stars. That's all I want.
That's all we need.
That's all we need.
A lot of locals listen here.
A lot of locals.
You know, when you go to a restaurant, it's full of the locals of country.
Yeah.
And this is good listening right here.
Yeah, right? Just review it. Locals only.
Share it. 5 stars. Tell a friend. Send a clip. Like a cheek. Lick a bit.
Lick a bit. Suck a tit. Rub a clit.
And
we hope you guys have enjoyed the apps. We are going to release the Al Capone Patreon at some point. But I honestly, you know what, guys? I'm sensing a lack of desire. I feel like I'm hosting a show and you're not giving me the energy I need because we keep teasing this currently non-existent Al Capone episode and none of you are even signing up to look at it. Sign the fuck up and maybe we'll do it.
How about you sign the fuck up?
How about you sign the fuck up? How about you give us $5 of the fuck month?
Please.
Please.
I can't be on Feet Finder anymore.
I can. I sold a fucking... the guy gave me $100 for 4 picks the other day.
Can you like send him my number?
I don't know, dude.
I'll give you a couple of shots.
All right.
I got good feet.
Send me a portfolio.
Okay.
Give me a footfolio.
Yeah. I tried to do it. A portfolio?
Yeah. Portfolio. Follow us on Instagram and stuff, at Zach Russell Comedy.
Yeah, I'm Charles_Engel. I'm about to start posting real short reels.
Real shorts.
Real short reels.
Yeah, you're trying to get that engagement, trying to pop off.
RSRs.
Like, yep. What? Oh, real short reels.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you are a $10 member of the Patreon, you can submit questions and stuff for us and kind of like be a pseudo-producer of the pod, dictate what we talk about. That goes back into your ears. That's full profit, all profit for
that's
you.
Huge ROI.
Huge ROI.
Huge pod ROI.
Uh-huh. So, yeah, we appreciate you guys listening. We are going to get back to the history next week. We're probably going to do Stephen Baldwin.
Yeah, what a freak.
What a fucking weirdo. Yeah, big into God. He smiles like the Joker. He made a Christian skateboarding documentary. He has a weird tattoo that he's ashamed of, and he doesn't like his brother's impression of Trump. He's a real loose cannon.
Mm-hmm.
It's funny, though, when you look him up, he's, like, famous enough that you have to scroll through, like, his IMDb before you actually find, like, here's how weird this guy is. You have to go through his, like, credentials.
He hides the weirdness.
Well, he's just become enough that he can put it on page 2 of Google.
That's hilarious.
You gotta scroll back in time to find some dirt on Stevie. But we'll unearth it, and we'll bring his sorry ass into the light. Look, I don't know if he's a bad guy, actually.
Yeah, we did get that email from Nick Cage's brother.
Yeah, we got a pretty spicy email from Mark.
Mark Kroll, or whatever his name was.
So we got to try to get him on the pod. Hopefully he didn't break his other foot, because that was this excuse he gave me before.
Jesus.
As I broke my foot. I'm like, sure. Buddy, we'll wheel you out here.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't know if you knew this, but we're sitting the whole time.
Yeah. This
during
is
the podcast.
This is the pod for you.
You think we're on a treadmill here? You think we're on yoga balls balancing on our feet? What do you think we're doing?
Did you break your mouth?
You think we're wall sitting for 2 hours? Yeah. Idiot.
Holding the 45?
Yeah. Holding the 45? Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah, well.
You got a mic attached to the 45. Yeah. You're trying to smoke through the 45. I saw a guy make a bowl out of, you follow fucking Schmacked?
No.
It was just a bunch of pictures of asses, and it was like tacos and weed for 3 months or a night with me. I'm like, this is not the content I want. I want fun weed content.
Yeah.
And this guy once was, this is what I wanted. He was smoking a pizza. He had made a bowl out of the pizza crust. And so he had a big, in the middle of the pizza, right at the crisscross, right? The top of the crust where you'd make a cross. Hole right there, put the weed in, drilled through the crust to make like the pipe. And then I guess he had a carb on the other side of the crust, and he was just smoking out of it. And then I'm like, this motherfucker better take a bite of the pizza at the end of the video.
Did he?
And he did.
Wow.
I liked it. Sent it to all my friends.
That's great.
And that's what you got to do with our content. If you want to make pizza bowls, if you want us to make pumpkin bongs, if you want me to hollow out Charles and smoke out of his ear, I'll do it for likes. Please follow, continue to listen, send it to your friends. We appreciate it. We're trying to get some sponsors in here soon so you can skip through ads and we can make some cash.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you again for listening, and we'll be back next week.
All right. See you then.
See you then.
Bye.
Bye.